Do the Kings have an answer? Using up a lot of energy to come back. Vezinkov got it! Oh! It's the Sasha Vezinkov game! Moody for an answer. Oh, you bet! Sharp shooting on display. Moses Moody cans a couple of threes.
Well, it's just what we thought this game would come down to.
Stephen Curry back on the floor. Two-point Warriors lead. 4:46 left in regulation. Malik Monk gets by Moody. Monk, no. Thompson with a rebound. Here come the Warriors now, up two, trying to extend their lead. Green with Lyles on him. And that's going to go the other way. Thompson's going to be called for the foul.
Didn't miss a shot. 4 for 4, 3 for 3 from three. A little surprised he's coming out, but probably a little tired, to be honest.
Fox sets up Lyles, and he is plowed by Draymond Green. Free throws for Lyles. Second miss for Lyles. Sixers and the Nuggets against Suns. Missed them both. Sabonis keeps it alive. Another chance here for Sacramento. They're down two. Fox, step back three for the lead. No good. Sabonis, another offensive board. Monk for the lead. No good. And Wiggins finally secures the defensive board. Kings with 10 offensive rebounds, but the Warriors still lead. Thompson lost it on the way up. Saves it. Curry open. Curry got it! Stephen Curry on a broken play.
That's the only way he got open, is because everybody started going after the loose ball. Curry was open. Great find by Klay Thompson.
Vezinkov misses. Remember, the Kings can still win the group if they lose by 11 or fewer points. Oh, no, not! Oh, and Looney blocked from behind! That was Lyles with the defensive gem. And a hot pass through the legs of Vezinkov. These guys are gassed right now. Fatigue is a factor.
And Steve Kerr can't believe that Looney didn't get the foul call, though.
Green gives it right back. Curry, and that's a kickball of Vezinkov.
Golden State's won 10 of the last 11 regular season meetings. They beat them in the playoffs last year, winning game 7 in a 20-point blowout here.
Curry, and that's going to be an offensive foul. The kick out by Curry is going to give the ball back to the Kings.
And Steve Kerr contemplating a challenge, but this would be his last time out if he loses it. Yeah, he kicked out. Yep. That's a good call.
Yeah, JT Orr right there on the call.
Steve Kerr is going to challenge it. If
the shooter abnormally extends his right leg, making contact with the defender. The offensive foul stands as called. The challenge by Golden State is unsuccessful. They lose their timeout, and they are out of challenges.
And a good call there, in my opinion, by the officials.
So, Sacramento with the ball, down 5. Fox now gets to the paint, gives it right back to Monk. Here's Monk for 3. Short. Wiggins flying high with the rebound. 7th board for Wiggins. Warriors have beaten the Kings twice already this season. 3rd matchup of the young season. Curry missed it, and Herter with a rebound.
I dodged the bullet there. Fox fell asleep.
Now Monk gives it to Herter. Vezinkov, why not? No good. Shine coming off a little bit. Vezinkov was on fire early in this 4th quarter.
Well, he's played a long time now without rest. Probably getting a little bit tired.
Here's Kareem to the basket. No good. Looney with the rebound. Hits the deck. And that's going to be a foul. Herter called for the foul. And Looney comes up short. Chris Paul, lower leg soreness. Missed them both. 5-point game. Kings down with the ball. Fox, crossover. Oh, Curry with a strip, but a foul. And Fox will go back to the line. Six free throws. And True with that one. An interesting call to finish this game.
Well,
are we going for the win, or are we going for the Group C victory?
Nah, they're just going for the win at this point.
Of course.
They're not going to play hurry up. But Sacramento would really like to get a win over this team.
No shot. Curry hits the deck. He's fouled. Two teams have been in the bonus since the 5.5 minute mark of this.
Free throw shot.
Curry hits them both. 6-point game. Fox to Herder.
Great rotation by the Warriors there. Excellent hustle by Steph Curry.
And here's Monk on the drive. No, he kicks it. Extra pass. Fox for three. Got it. Mazenkov with the extra pass. Sets up Fox from good to great. 3-point game now. Approaching the 1 minute mark. Curry drives it. Curry to Green. 3-pointer. No good. Wiggins with the follow. Under a minute to go. Group C is in the Kings' reach. Can they pull this one out? Fox hangs and is fouled. In a 5-point game. Yeah, Fox. One out of two for Fox.
Sacramento in good shape for getting into the knockout.
Monk with a steal. Fox. Thompson right on him. Herder. Extra pass. Monk now. Sidestep. Three-pointer. It's good. A steal and a three. It's a 1-point game. And now Group C is in the books. But the win in question is Green turns it over.
That's 20 turnovers, Brian, for the Warriors. 20 turnovers and 42 free throws for their opponent. Hard to win that way.
Fox falls down. Did they get the timeout? They did.
Again, two straight turnovers, 20 for the game. They've sent Sacramento to the line 42 times. These are the Warriors' Achilles heels. The Warriors' only chance now to move on in the in-season tournament, Brian, this game's got to go overtime.
Kings have a chance to take the lead here. Wiggins with five fouls. Monk drives on him. Monk hangs. And he scores! What a basket! Malik Monk gives the Kings the lead. Clock ticks. Curry with the ball. Puts it up. That's it. The Kings win. A furious comeback. It is Monk.
A lot of the times trying to confuse Anthony. Let's see how he approaches it today.
Big fella right into his chest. So back and forth we go. The centers.
Lakers wasting no time trying to exploit it.
Embiid from the left wing, his favorite spot outside the arc. And
Joel. Joel trying to hold contact so he knows where LeBron is at all times.
Tyrese Maxey from way outside. To Embiid.
More flex offense. Cut along the baseline.
Maxey off the Embiid screen. And Tyrese Maxey has another.
Gravel, double dribble, something.
Offensive foul.
Something.
Embiid lays it up and in.
Just bully ball.
Harris in the dunker spot. Jump stop.
Nice move. That's a tough one.
Embiid, the rip down rebound, and the finish. And four of his six threes late, put up 25 points, but Sixers won that ball game in overtime. Tyrese Maxey, he is looking.
Watch this again, little two-man game. Joel just leaves it for him, sets the screen. Maxey able to turn baseline jumper.
Pat Bev left alone. Embiid another offensive rebound and another putback.
Hayes is going to have
mentally in. Obviously the way he plays a bit. Maxey from outside. Oh my goodness.
Nice tap out from Nico. Great idea. Got to stop ball.
Davis the spin and the swat by Joel Embiid.
That's one way to stop the ball. Fun, but this is even better. Watch this.
Yeah.
The stark rejection. Subject of our discussion. It's pretty cool. Only get to see him once a year.
Tobias, no. Covington the tap out. Embiid straight on triple. Yes, sir.
So so you've got to make sure that other aspects of your game don't slip either.
Another between the legs. Maxey's step back. Long two is good. Joel keeping this one. Harris. Into the paint. Great move by Tobias Harris.
Got to make sure you nip that in the bud. You don't want to make that an extensive run.
Great look from Batum down to Embiid. Really liking the chemistry. Shooting a career low from beyond the arc this season. Under 28%. Batum too strong. Embiid. Another offensive rebound and putback. And Davis not happy about it.
Yeah, Nico was in his face. That makes a huge difference as opposed to the two open looks where he knocked him down.
Catch and shoot the Anthony Melton. It's good. 14.
All the way to the cup. Very little resistance offered up.
A lot more energy already from the Lakers in this second half. Back-to-back triples from DeAnthony. Season best 13 made threes in the first half of the Sixers.
Good luck.
Two good cuts. Joel finds it. I'll have to navigate. Kate Scott, Taryn Hatcher with you here on NBC Sports Philadelphia. Appreciate all of you watching tonight on NBA TV as well as Joel gets the roll.
New Orleans 3-4 on the road. Coming up on the 3-minute mark. Zion out front, Collins. The pass out, a little 16-foot jumper straight away. And Ingram makes it look easy. Ingram, 8 straight points for the Pelicans. And a 25-point night, right at past his season high, or season average now. Simone, here's Kessler. Keontae George, flick of the wrist. And this young kid, ice water. Drains a big triple, a Kia three-pointer.
3 for 8 from three tonight.
114-107. Keontae George. With 19 in his pocket. And the rebound to Utah. George will let the clock run. Clarkson on a runner. Just missed it. And it's going to be off Valanciunas.
Keontae George, again, absolutely fearless, and he knows in the moment what when. Simone with a nice find to Walker, and then a quick three, and he doesn't hesitate. You know, you hear coaches all the time say, 0.5, make that decision in 0.5 seconds. Well, he rises, elevates over Brandon Ingram, who's a much taller player at 6'8". Quick decision.
That's a good Keontae off the pure three. Valanciunas a rebound. Zion gives it up. Another two to go. Flip and slide inside. Tough shot. Down it goes by Marshall. But Najee really turned it up a notch in the second quarter. Now 14 for the Pelicans. A 5-point lead for the Jazz. Big possession here on the offensive end. Screen, Kessler, Keontae breaks loose, looks inside out. Clarkson, he'll dribble drive, gives it up, pass it out. Simone, up and out. And the rebound, won by Zion. He took it away from Valanciunas. Here's Ingram, to the corner. Three, wow. Now, Holly off the three from Herbert Jones. He has a 10-point game. We all of a sudden have a buckle up night in SLC. It's a 2-point lead, 114-112. The crowd on their feet at Delta Center on this celebration of 50 years of Jazz basketball. JC jumping in and out. On the floor, no call. Big possession on the defensive end for Utah. Zion takes a stare at Collins. Under a minute to play. In fact, 42 and running. 10 on the shot clock. Triples away. Short rebound. Simone. And the ball finds its way to Collins. And now Clarkson claps his hands and he wants the ball. He just barely got over the timeline. Jazz holding on to a 2-point lead with the ball. 10 to shoot. 23 to play. Clarkson. Step back three. Short. Ball's out. Chased down. Fontecchio on the floor, and we got a loose ball foul with 10.7 to play.
Wow, Simone is beside him, putting them on the line.
quickly inside to Zion. Passes on Ingram. Two. No. Rebound. Loose. Kiante saves it. And the ball down. The Jazz will win in a scramble against New Orleans. Wild finish. And Utah has won five straight against New Orleans and SLC.
Here's DeAndre Jordan. 10 years with the LA Clippers. Nice bounce pass, and Reggie Jackson is away. Jackson, also a former ex-Clipper. Guarding corner threes, they're giving up 43% on those threes. Now, Kentavious Caldwell-Pope steps in. He's got a 15-footer, and he knocks it in.
But I feel like he's kind of brought himself down to fit in with the team.
The lob to Jordan is a beauty. So a couple of ex-Clippers connecting. And the Nuggets could tie with a three, get closer with a two. Reggie Jackson coming off a good game. Porter is wide open. And he drills it, and that is a defensive error. As he has been in his Denver Nuggets career. Former San Diego State star with his fourth point. The Clippers up by a couple. And once again to DeAndre Jordan. So Jordan having his way. Picked up by James Harden. Got a good look. Baseline and Reggie Jackson.
That seems to slowly be flushing itself out right now.
But more playing time will do that. Now Reggie Jackson's in the lane. KCP, great fake. Got a 17-footer. Nails it. And DeAndre Jordan back in. Has the rebound. Reggie over Zubac. Got it! So Reggie Jackson, 20 last night. And with 7:17 to go, second quarter. Let's see if the Nuggets could get 11 points in a row. Reggie Jackson hoists from the corner, and Reggie is hot. Too long, and Reggie Jackson knifes in for the rebound. Clippers went Rip Van Winkle there, fell asleep. Reggie, oh my! And Reggie Jackson, 45-44 Nuggets. Playing shorthanded and playing well.
Oh!
Jackson off the feed from DeAndre Jordan.
He wanted to take foul. Watch his cut. Fake one way. That was actually Paul George on him. Man down below doesn't see a lane. That's just a good play. Fake. Boom.
That is a prime mover. Nuggets playing even with the improved LA Clippers, winning four of their last five. Reggie in the lane. Scoop it up and in.
This time they get man on him. He just crossed Zubac, played with Zubac, knows what his capabilities are.
That's eight total rebounds for DeAndre Jordan, and the Nuggets lead by a couple.
Lob to Jordan!
Lob City once again. Oop here. What's better, alley or the oop, or the finish by DeAndre Jordan? He's a big target in
there. But you see Zubac come all the way over to help on the one-on-one by Reggie.
Nuggets a 21-9 run. Don't forget the Nuggets back in action against the Houston Rockets at home next Wednesday. And the lay-in is good. Give up five in a row to open the third quarter. Sling it. Holiday for three. Yes. He's been a good three-point shooter throughout his career. And Reggie Jackson. Guarded by Mann. Shakes him. 15-footer on the way. That's good. Reggie going to launch on the dribble drive in the lane. Tough shot. Needs a bounce, and he gets it. A hometown bounce for the former hometown kid. So he did a little bit of everything. Had great energy. The Nuggets looking for some scoring here. You got DeAndre Jordan, and that will do it. DeAndre Jordan, just as he did.
Shooting in that quarter, just 1 of 6 from three.
Reggie Jackson, who had 18 in the first half. Just 4 in that third quarter, and that's a good start for the Nuggets. Well, the Nuggets, can they rally? Got plenty of time. Down by 7. Strother, quick trigger. Yes!
And you know what? That was a bad pass for Reggie.
Well, the Nuggets could tie or take the lead with a 3. Reggie Jackson. DeAndre Jordan, right-handed kaboom! The Nuggets have the momentum with 7.5 to go. Pick and roll has worked. Reggie in the lane, and it's good again. Don't forget, next Nuggets telecast on Altitude. Houston Rockets coming to town Wednesday.
alley-oop.
Oh. Jordan again. Reggie and Jordan work so beautifully on the pick and roll.
Into you. Watch where this lob comes from. That's one hand picking up off the dribble.
DeAndre Jordan finishing tonight with a flourish. Looks like the 25-year-old.
That's not basketball either. Good no call.
Now Rich Jackson inside, lay it up and in, and he is torching anybody who's trying to stop him tonight. Reggie Jackson lost the handle, scoop it. Porter's got it on the dribble drive. Here he comes. Jackson for three. Oh my! Reggie Jackson! Reggie Jackson. Wow. A bucket here would be huge. Reggie Jackson by Harden. Scoop it up and in!
And that could have been a foul.
Reggie looking for an outlet. Kawhi's on him. Reggie over to Porter. Biggest shot of the night. Porter got it! MP long J. Nuggets can burn some clock here. Reggie throw it ahead. Peyton Watson's got a dunk. And he puts it away! And the Denver Nuggets are heading towards one of the most improbable wins. Well, 40.9. They are heading to the exits here at Crypto.com.
After a 1-4 road trip, gives up a load of paint points. Second most in the NBA. All 8 Cavalier points have come in that paint. Now, make it all 10.
I love it. Go to the paint.
Murray, the longtime San Antonio Spur, was signed prior to last season. Mitchell, right to the basket. Sunday night in Boston, he scored 23 of the Hawks, 29 bench points. Mitchell right around Griffin to the basket. Double clutches, draws a foul, and Donovan Mitchell has a chance for the three-point play.
Transition, nice crossover. Again, he can contort his body. It's incredibly so powerful, so strong, but he can just step away from contact. There's the foul. Great body control, knocks it down.
Hunter picks up the personal. Mitchell has opened this game 3-for-6 from the bench. He grabs it. His Cavaliers trail 51-43 as Mitchell right around Griffin to the basket, puts it up and in, and has a chance for the three-point play.
Backwards. The defender's going backwards. It's almost impossible to stay in front of him. He's so strong, and he's also agile enough to put you in an awkward position when you're trying to guard him. It puts you at a bad angle for his basketball team.
Young lob for Capella. Only got a hand up. Capella lost the ball. Comes to Mitchell. Capella's one of the best at that in terms of pick and roll. Mitchell throws in the breaks and nails a three.
Ends up with a fast break opportunity, and this is what we've been waiting on. We want to see that number 45 start cooking.
LeVert goes back door. He'll find Garland. Extra pass to Struce. Another extra pass. Mitchell puts it on the floor, and how about that?
Spectacular play. It's good when the Cavs do their, when they rebound or when they defend deep into the possession. You know, the Hawks don't crash the board super hard, so you're going to get the basketball back. Yeah, that makes a lot of sense that you see that at this level. Everyone's good. Everyone's been a great player at some point. Everybody wants to get theirs, and sometimes you just lose sight of what that means to the team.
Donovan Mitchell, too prolific, a three-level scorer, and he has a plus defender and Hunter leaning back, leaning the wrong way. Mobley reaches for it, somehow comes out of the pack with it. Struce finds Mitchell, look out! Mitchell to the basket, he finger rolls and scores.
Look at that pass from Struce. Great find, such unselfish basketball. That's Cavalier basketball.
He draped on him, as if to say, I've had enough of these two tonight.
He's getting worn out, no doubt.
Mitchell over Capella. Mitchell now has 29.
I got to spend $2.
Baseless freeze.
Spend $2.
Order some fries or something.
They do have good fries.
Wash it down with something.
That's a good point.
He'll find Mobley. No time to take the foot off the accelerator as Struce to the basket. Back to Mitchell. The ball movement continues as Mitchell swivels inside. Finger rolls it home. And looking for Capella. That was Struce who read it from behind. Out goes Garland. Garland along with Mitchell. He'll lay it up. He missed the shot. Mitchell, though, pokes it in. Donovan now has a double-double. 33.
One and done. Good rebound by the Cavs. We talked about that.
Mitchell draws the foul, puts it up and in, and Donovan Mitchell has a chance for the three-point play.
You defend so well, and you eliminate those second-chance opportunities that usually sting you or bite you.
Head on to the knockout stage.
I think you give it another minute. And if you're still scoring, you go for it. But if not...
You ended last season with the Lakers. Nice feed. Lillard out of the combo. Sails in for two. Dwayne Miami's ball.
Right here, he comes off the pick and roll. He could have took that shot, but you know what? Selfishly unselfish. I'm going to look for my guy.
And I understand there was no shot blocking because Bam was guarding Giannis on that drop.
Lillard on top. Makes a move into Richardson. Love had it. Cleaned on that baseline by Dink.
I agree, but they're not a championship team yet. They're aspiring to be a championship team.
Look at that.
And, you know, being down 26, open things up, and here we go. Now we have a game.
Lillard working shot over Richardson's three is perfect. Adebayo in stride.
Really pushing the pace. Low layup by Adebayo.
4-on-3, Lillard to Giannis and over Robinson. Play for free at NBA.com/bracket challenge or the NBA app. Middleton wheels and finds Giannis who's cutting inside.
The question going forward is, to me, Big Fella, him and Giannis are going to have to get on the same page. Nice move there on cue by Damian Lillard.
That's it. You know, they're not always looking for the superstars. They're definitely looking for guys that are going to work hard, guys that are going to listen, and guys that are going to excel at doing the little things.
That would be a pump fake for Bam.
Bam's got 15. He's shooting 49%. Lillard, three!
Right back at you, no hesitation. Came off the pick and roll knowing he was going to take that shot. Still so effective, even at his age. Pick and pop. Great shot by Kevin Love.
Here's the two-time MVP, Giannis Antetokounmpo.
He's up to 14 now.
Giannis with a three.
Once you hit that three, though, two in a row, I'm telling you, it gets you in the rhythm.
Richardson's only shooting 27% from three. Lillard, Lopez, Antetokounmpo, 21 points a game. The Bucks working it in. Antetokounmpo, hard to contain with the game.
You teach fundamentals there, Shaq.
I don't know.
Good first move.
Ooh-wee.
What a play. 6 rebounds and 3 assists.
All right, so I got to ask you, Shaq. Now, foul there on Bam Adebayo. And he said, and this is Bam's quote, not mine, that he puts Giannis.
Antetokounmpo with another rebound, 7. The spin, the drive, sashing for 2. What a play. 4 of 9. He's 2 of 4 from 3. Moves on the rookie, takes it in.
Oh, did you see how he went into the body of Hawkes?
Lillard with 16 now, Reg.
Look at this. Right into the body to create that space with the up and under with the left hand. Look how he goes to his right.
This kid right here.
It's the biggest lead for Miami. Lillard dives, got it, fouled.
For one here, and takes on 3 black jerseys on his way to a potential and one. Exclusively for Bam Adebayo.
I was just about to ask you, Rez, who you think the go-to guy is going to be with 6 minutes left.
Lillard, sweet fadeaway.
I think that's the thinking of these teams. I'm going to have a free trip to Vegas with a showcase.
Along with the championship trophy and $500,000.
Bullseye, Lillard.
I already told you, it's Dame time now. 5 minutes or less, Dame has to have the ball, period.
He's got 26. 29 from Giannis. 4.5 to go. Lowry's got 16 with 6 assists. He finds Adebayo, who scoops it for the driving Martin.
Great basketball play. Very unselfish. First easy layup.
How about the back cut there by Caleb Martin? His man got caught ball watching. Got to stay attached to Dame.
Lillard, 3-0. With the rebound pulled down by Josh Richardson. He'll float. Working on Middleton. Antetokounmpo. As they clear out.
Yep. Look at the footwork. Watch the footwork.
Adebayo. Poked away. Great defense by Antetokounmpo. And it's Lillard to Giannis.
Oh.
Right into Adebayo. Foul called on Antetokounmpo.
That was offensive.
with a foul to give, and here comes Martin. Three timeouts for the Bucks and two for the Heat. Three and a half in the game. Hawkins, Antetokounmpo poking it away again. Oh. Saved the ball and out of bounds with it with eight on the shot clock. Well, how about the big names flying all over the floor? Lowry three.
Oh, what a shot! Kyle Lowry!
Looked like Poole Richardson. Looked like Poole Richardson.
EJ. Antetokounmpo three. Rebound off the fingertips of Adebayo. Back to Lillard. A triple.
This is who needs the ball. Giannis, take it from me. Give it to the guy that's a prolific scorer.
Think about that position. You had the one guy you wanted taking a three in Giannis, but again, couldn't secure the defensive rebound.
29 apiece for Antetokounmpo and for Lillard.
They're getting the ball down to Hawkins versus Lillard.
Hawkins taking it. Oh, and it's a travel and it's a turnover on Miami.
Don't you ever question the master.
Oh, I don't know.
Don't you ever question the master of down low footwork.
Again, I don't think you could have played in today's game.
Oh, no. Lillard and Antetokounmpo have combined for 58 points. Start and stop.
Look at this defense.
Jab stepping, shot clock at four. Lillard in. Knocked away. What a reception by Adebayo.
Give me that, says Bam Bam.
2 seconds on the shot clock. They take it in. Middleton, corner three. What a shot. Make it a two. He was on the line. What a difficult shot. Bucks by two. Approaching two to play. Lowry. Adebayo. 15-footer. With the rebound. Fought for Beasley. Lillard. And here come the Bucks. If they win, they clinch a knockout round berth in the in-season tournament.
And watch the dagger three from Dame here.
Middleton with the shot clock at six. Hawkins is defending. Middleton with the spin. Fires. Oh,
he's
good.
Back, he's back, Reggie. He's getting back at mid-season form.
And here's the thing for Milwaukee. You've got two closers because that was Chris Middleton the last few years for the Bucks.
Bucks run a 7-0 run. Fighting hard inside. With a whistle. Bench of the Heat. And a team has been hit by injuries. The top two scorers are out.
They're picking up Dame full court here with Josh Richardson trying to keep the ball out of his hands.
This is Malik Beasley. Lowry's on him. Middleton's got it. Screen by Giannis. Up high, knocked away. They left at the same time with Martin and Hawkins, and they sure did.
They called a foul.
Big numbers again. Big free throws.
All I had to do was hit 19 of them, Kevin. Not 20, not 21, 19.
19. Now 31. And Giannis from the free throw line has hit his last 8 free throws.
2 big free throws from Giannis right there. Puts Milwaukee up by 4.
Richardson's got the ball. Slithers in the paint. Adebayo. 31 for Bam.
Oh, they called the ticky-tack on Richardson.
Unfortunate. Unfortunate foul. Right,
and a technical foul.
But it was a foul on Josh Richardson. And it happened right into the face of the official David Guthrie. Lillard, I mean, it's almost like a three-pointer.
Which tonight they got 62. They have done that in 5 of the last 6 games. They did it just once in the first 12. Lowry will drive. Lillard will defend. This is over the guns.
Team ready, Kevin. They will not go away quietly.
Richardson sticks on Middleton. It's a 3-point game. Lillard with it. Lowry's on him. Middleton taking it in. Off to Lopez. Shot clock at six with a flush. And a timeout taken by Miami. Robinson with the three. Rebound by Middleton. If the Bucks go on to win, they will win this group. Then it will be Indiana, Boston, and the Knicks. If Miami would win, here they are, double Lillard. He wants a timeout, and he gets it. If in the in-season tournament, in the knockout round, that will feature single elimination games in the quarterfinals. The semifinals will be in Vegas for the championship next Saturday. Middleton's got it. Lowry's on him. They trap him in the corner. And it's out to Lopez.
Oh.
And that'll do it. On to DeCumbo. Comes up with his 33rd point. Richardson with the three. Rebound Bucks. It's over, and the Bucks have clinched a knockout round berth. In a hard-fought game with Miami.
Yep. It's not been a well-played game, but it's been a lot of energy and a lot of competitive flair, wouldn't you say?
There's no cheap whistles these last few possessions, and both teams finding a rhythm. Two words, Nas Reed. To go in regulation.
Gosh, there were some other great things that Minnesota did. I don't mean to focus on the negative, but that's something that they can't let happen, especially with SGA back on the floor now.
Isaiah Joe, good look out of the timeout. SGA comes up with the ball. Lou Dort, he's been battling foul trouble most of the night. Into Wiggins. Wiggins, a kick out. Dort for three. Brick, rebound, snatched out of there by Brown, who's fouled by Isaiah Joe.
If you want to know the reason why Minnesota is so good defensively this season, all you got to know is just two words, Rudy Gobert. I mean, what he does in terms of making people afraid to shoot at the rim, that possession was a good example. Then Troy Brown digging out the rebound.
I believe they're getting Chet Holmgren with the foul, and his penalty is in effect. Second foul on Holmgren. That's the 15th foul. And so Gobert will shoot free throws, 434. And Gobert hits the first.
I didn't see if it was intentional that time.
Look on the right side.
So they're playing Hack-a-Rudy right there.
Hack-a-Rudy. They are daring Gobert to make free throws in this tight ball game with 4:34 to go.
They're trying to play him off the floor because Degnault knows how impactful Rudy Gobert is on the defensive end. So if they can get him off the floor.
Oh, Gobert says take that, Richie.
Yeah, he's not getting played off the floor tight. Tom Thibodeau tried doing that in this building with the New York Knicks.
We'll see if OKC tries that again. Here's Holmgren in the corner. Driving, hook, no, Wiggins the rebound. Holmgren won't go mid-range. Oh, swallowed up by Gobert, nothing there. Isaiah Joe can't do anything. Holmgren, air ball, tap over to Reed. Suffocating defense. 4 minutes to go, 5-point lead. Anthony Edwards questionable to return with the hip injury. Conley. In and out. Alexander Walker has it. Brown gives it back to Alexander Walker. Penetrating. His pass batted and stolen. 20th turnover of the night for Minnesota.
That's the way to show bodies, Mike.
Holmgren. Outside look to Wiggins. Leaves it for Holmgren, who throws it down. 3-point game. Solid move and feed by Aaron Wiggins. It's 95-92.
Towns will check in next dead ball. Conley, outside look, Naz Reid. Gonna back down SGA, turns and kisses it off the window. SGA spinning, tough face, twitch.
Naz Reid with the grab dribble counter move, drop step, right hand jump hook. We saw the lefty counter in the first half. SGA is unbelievable. He's shot making.
Brown gonna drive and try to thread the needle to Gobert. And it'll be Timberwolves basketball.
Yes and no. I would say for the most part they have not. And then the last one with the possession battle, they have not taken care of the basketball.
Towns can't hit from deep. And a battle between SGA and Brown. Seconds. Brown will fire and hit. Wow, from Duluth. 5-point ball game. SGA, tough lay-in, no rebound, Gobert.
Great contest by Towns. Came all the way across that time to give Shai Gilgeous-Alexander the business.
.115 to go.
Yeah, loading up on Carl.
Anderson. 5 seconds on the clock. Crossover. Inside. Kick out. Conley. No good. Rebound Dort. 1 minute to go. Pressure time for OKC. Williams into the chest of Brown. And that will be free throws.
Rebound. Wilson killed on the glass here. 49-35 advantage. Confusion going. Gobert pick and roll game with Mike Conley. This is always a good idea.
Here we go. Conley gets it across. He's watched closely by Dort. Anderson looking for Towns. Finds him. Double comes. Brown another three. Can't hit. Battle for the rebound. Anderson has it. And now Brown will take some time off the clock. Conley gives it to Brown. Brown driving. Hanging. In a Timberwolves uniform for Troy Brown Jr. 31 seconds to close it out. SGA kick out. Holmgren for three. Kansas.
Differential is right there at the point of controversy. You want to try to play, but a couple seconds is not enough.
Conley gets it across. Finds Anderson. He's one that you'd want to foul if you're OKC. They don't. Brown. It's at the Towns, who is fouled. Big.
You got to make free throws.
Big free throws for Towns. SGA gets it across quickly. Working on Anderson. Down the lane and throws it down with 5.6. You have to get it in cleanly.
You got a timeout if you're Minnesota, too.
And there is that timeout.
The only team that's younger is San Antonio. Got to get it in.
Got to get it in. Anderson taking his time. Finds Brown, who is immediately fouled by Lou Dort. And so Troy Brown Jr.
in this situation. So they went down and scored quickly. SGA got the layup. Now Troy Brown
to send the game to overtime. Brown can't hit. Dort the rebound. Timberwolves up three. Giddy finds SGA. Gonna fire from deep. Can't hit. Anderson the board. Timberwolves win.
New system with new coach, and they're definitely committed to a defensive end. That's great.
And no surprise here,
Dylan
Brooks.
There's no defense against that.
gets blocked. The rookie already making, again, his presence felt here early in the game. This time it's Jabari Smith Jr. No defense for that as Luka nails the three-pointer over it. Grant Williams out of the game as well. There will be a timeout coming here for the next head ball. Probably part of their key to being the best defensive team in the league this year is Jones knocks down that win over the Rockets and what stood as the Mavericks team high for scoring in a game until Luka's 60 almost Luka, 11 months ago.
Luka walked in. That was a fun night because, I mean, he should have won the game high of the win.
That was Brooks who missed the bank shot. And here's Dallas running the other way. Nicely done. Alley-oop upstairs.
Double teamed.
Yeah.
This one flipped out. Just buying time for the middle of the floor. I think it was more so his shot selection and offensively, which I think he's got a better feel for it now, especially with Canada over the summer. But really understanding when to take those shots.
Over the years, I got more comfortable and with the language, too, and I could actually talk back a little bit. Nice shot.
Great recognition here.
Yes. They went both with Jones Jr. Good pass.
Just one of many who had his pathway to the NBA paved by the guy to my right.
Step
back. Luka on the money. Luka leads Dallas with 16 points. Three of them here are the Mavs, up by 11. Beat Denver in an in-season tournament game. Smith had 16 points and 15 rebounds that night. And he defends Luka all the way until the end of the possession. And Doncic...
Lucky. Mine was super lucky. Oh, it was off the glass too, right?
That's right.
Was that over Melo?
Ooh! Lively. Two-hand rim rock. The other end.
Yeah, you can't do that.
Can't leave the guy paint the road.
Wow. Yeah. So see how many blocks I could have had? I could have had as many as Mutombo.
Clearly.
Maybe.
Yeah.
Ball Houston, that's her first foul of the quarter.
Brooks had... They're trying not to switch. They're keeping Brooks on it.
Luka scores.
Talk to him.
Talk to him.
Talk to him.
Was just putting in. Against Dylan Brooks.
Yeah, he's got to work hard, but hey, he's so skilled. Spin, no. I think Jones almost rotated back to his own instead of just going weak. That messed up the whole rotation.
Chance for Dallas to get the 3 points right back.
And Luka just does a great job of putting that ball out there.
Yeah. Pick and roll.
Dime.
Roll.
Holmes the roller.
Nice.
And Luka, that one falls home, and Dallas has crept back to within a point.
The good old days.
The Landry Center near Baylor Hospital was the former Mavs practice facility. Luka beats the shot clock. Never reset because the initial look going into tonight, just 18 fouls a game for Dallas, fifth fewest. But
I think that's Şengün now and Jones to get him out of the pick and roll.
And here's Luka to the cup.
Playing with more pace this year. You think it's been helpful?
Yeah, definitely. I like it. Our offense hasn't been really the problem.
Nice. And with that, tie game again.
Pace, and it wasn't something that, you know, they can sustain, especially with young players.
Great pass, wide open three. Dallas in front. They surge in front. Since early in the third quarter, here she is.
Drop it back off.
And so the Rockets, for a moment, stop the bleeding. Dallas had lifted the lead.
Too little.
Spin move and score for Luka. 37 in the game. Luka.
Yeah, got Green on it.
And Luka against Green. Blocked shot. Jalen Green. And a save-in attempt is picked up by Luka.
Oh, no.
And he puts it in. Some Luka magic. First in the last 2 minutes.
He went with the third.
That was actually a good block. And then kind of made. But look how easy it makes it look. I mean, I'm telling you, his horse game is out of control. 41, huh?
41 tonight.
A quiet,
how fitting.
A quiet 41.
Let's speak it into existence. There it is. 41.
You don't want them to develop any kind of confidence in this game.
AD over to D'Lo. Good little cut and dive that time by D'Angelo, and he's fouled by AD. With LeBron James. James was suspended, so was Stewart after the altercation. Russell got a good little baseline move. D'Lo looking to take charge. Underneath, that's where he could do some damage. He being Anthony Davis, a little jump hook. That was a brick from mid-range. Lob underneath, AD scoring. There's no whistle, apparently. He just went down hard. Back-to-back double-doubles at seven overall.
It's the rebounding that the Lakers have to be concerned with during.
Well, AD, look at that quickness down the lane to score, Stu.
The bench tonight, because I think with the addition of Reddish now coming in with him, they should be able to do something.
Underneath, going to the basket, D'Angelo Russell.
Talked about how efficient D'Angelo has been, penetrating and little ball fake, underhand scoop shot for a deuce, and then the early offense gets him the next basket. So,
a lot of Laker fans here tonight. These are local fans just waiting for something to happen. They're all into the Lions at this point. Make it 4 for 4 for D'Lo. Certainly helps on that end of the floor in a big time way. D'Lo looking to stay perfect and does.
Well, he's having his way.
25-14.
Wow.
Launched by
wow.
Livers. He wasn't shy about that one. D'Lo, is he 6 for 6? He is. Only averages 12.5 in his 15 career games against Detroit. Lowest against any opponent. He's already got 13. He's come off the bench now for the last four after starting the first 13. Throwing a DNP in the middle of that. Russell for three. Still has it.
Look at D'Angelo's last basket as they switched out. And the big says, I don't like this speed differential. And D'Angelo says, I like it a lot. Odd when they tried to pass the ball.
So the last line of defense, again, paying dividends. One Anthony Davis. AD on the way again with a mid-range. Rattle it in. Here they come attacking this defense. Which has given up 120 points or more. 9 times in the last 20.
Look at that play where D'Angelo makes the nice bounce pass to LeBron for the finish. The crowd loves it. So does LeBron, by the way.
Well, Detroit, they have...
You're young, you generally have more than the opposition.
They missed their last 9 shots. And the Lakers trying to take advantage right back, and they do so.
Both in 3 for the Pistons.
Second chance points pretty close. 5 for them, 6 for the Lakers. Torian in the corner. Rattle it in, number 12. Flashing some of that number 1 overall pick potential. LeBron going to try a 3. Boy, it's been a great year. Detroit, it's all about showing some fight. And that's something that they haven't been able to do when they get down big in games. D'Lo continues. Count it and 1.
Offensively, screened by AD. He waits, and then he attacks, gets fouled, and throws it up and throws it in.
All the way, Thompson challenged Davis. Tip once. Got it again. Lakers pick a pocket. Good pass up ahead for D'Lo. All the way, lay it up and in as LeBron found him streaking ahead on the leak out.
Another look at that play where Prince steals the ball and LeBron with the assist to D'Angelo for the easy deuce.
And they steal it again. The turnover machine that is Detroit. D'Lo long distance. Got it!
Boy, he's
got it on fire
to shoot the free throw.
Good times. D'Angelo Russell fouls on Ivy, his 4th.
That was a long range rainbow. The thing was way up
in hanging the air. Down he goes. Won't get the whistle. Lakers have it still though. Now it's Torian's turn. Got it, yes sir. Torian Prince, part of the conversation last night during the tournament games, as D'Lo hits it again. D'Angelo! AR's got it right wing side. D'Lo wants to go down the middle. Instead, puts the move on. Got it again! What a night for D'Angelo!
This shot here is ridiculous, though, so the defender really makes him arc it even more, and he just steps back and string.
Only fourth quarter.
Just fourth quarter, yeah.
Yeah, that might be too many rejected sandwiches. Franz Wagner gets 2 for the Magic.
Virgil Lawrence. That was Franz, wasn't it?
Yes.
Caught him a little off guard there.
Kuzma had 32 in their win at Detroit. Anthony Black on the delivery to Franz Wagner. Anthony cross court to Franz Wagner. Leaning in, spinning, and scoring off the glass. That's brilliant footwork.
And watch Franz. This is just a great job on the left-handed drive. Avdija cuts him off, but it doesn't matter.
It's almost 7 assists per turnover. Franz Wagner for 3. In the first half.
Magic lead the league, forcing 17 per game. Franz Wagner drills it for three. Franz leads the Magic in scoring with 17. Gets that screen from Batanze. Left-handed runner is a beauty by Franz Wagner.
That was a good defensive sequence started by Jalen Suggs. Good pressure.
Somebody forgot about Franz Wagner. Here's Franz at the other end. Steps back, fires for three, and gets three back in the face of Kuzma. Magic can't put him away. Anthony Black along that baseline. Wagner got it again. He is on fire. Franz Wagner gets the screen from his brother. Franz going into the body of Danford. Easy 2 points for Franz Wagner. To Shamet. Wants the dribble three. Short rebounded by Ingles. 6 seconds left. Ingles has time. Wagner for the dunk.
The rebound. Look. Several said, look at him flying up the floor, just outrunning everybody in white.
Booker with it, guarded by Barnes. He's done an outstanding job on Booker as well as Durant. Durant now just heating up. He's 11 for 27, and he's got 9 in the quarter. He's 28 overall. Raptors using clock. They've done a good job keeping this pace.
He's shooting 48%. Very efficient tonight.
OG the three doesn't go. Nurkic with a rebound. Here's Gordon. 4-point game. Gordon.
Nurkic has played big tonight. 17 points, 13 boards, giving him good minutes at the five spot.
Nurkic on the inside doesn't go. Good job by Pirtle contesting the shot. Here's Scotty spinning back around. Okoji doesn't go. Gets it back. Hangs on the rim and falls through. Scotty B having another fourth.
How bad do you want it? A man possessed. That next level, that next gear where it's every night, no matter where you're playing. But tonight, job well done.
Yep, he's been outstanding. Mentioned last night, minus 22. He's plus 13 tonight, and that is the best plus minus of anyone playing tonight. And then Siakam plus 8. OG Anunoby, he's even, but when you're going up against Kevin Durant, yeah, Booker, and
that's a
every other side, you take it, right?
That's a deceiving stat. You know, he's, you know, you're just out there, you're just trying to get a hand in the face every time, and you're dealing with greatness.
Anunoby picks up his third. It's the team's fifth with 3:25 to go, 29-point performance. And looking for 30.
Only one team foul on Phoenix here.
30 now for Durant. He's averaging 31.4, second in the NBA. 11 here in the fourth quarter.
And they are 95% from the line. They are fourth best in the NBA in free throw shooting. Remember I mentioned early in the game, free throw shooting, they want to be dealing with it. That's a strength it is.
Here's Durant, kicks it to Gordon, gets it back. Durant. That one pops out, last touch by Nurkic. They're going to say, no, it was Pascal. It's going to be Phoenix basketball. Remember, Raptors have already used
the
challenge. Yeah. Annika Mosier comes over and has a word with Bill Kennedy, and it's going to be Toronto basketball.
Give Bill Kennedy, the crew chief, credit. Says, you got it? Okay. We're rolling with it.
Season high 12 assists for Dennis Schroeder.
Bill Kennedy, an elite official.
Here's Schroeder. Shot short. 2:35 left. Raptors by 4. Nurkic in the corner. Koji gives it back to Nurkic. Backing in on Poeltl, spinning. Old school power game, and it's a 2-point game.
And there's Booker and Durant watching. Nurkic, big game tonight. 19 and 13, 6 assists.
Averaging 10 and 9 on the season.
Has not made a basket in the second half, Matt. Talk about clutch with a capital C.
5-point game, 2-possession game. Under 2 minutes left here. Durant in the paint. Short. Schroeder with it. Schroeder gives it to Scottie. Durant there. Raptors lead by 5. Barnes pulls it back out. He wants to go at KD. Gets by him, flips it up, doesn't go. And a foul, and it's going to go the other way. And it's going to be on Pascal Siakam. So Siakam picks up his 4. 1:25 left.
That's a big call because, Matt, here's a shot right here, knocking down the trifecta. Okay, that's a big call because there's a foul call. And now the balls, the Suns are able to walk up court because they're in the bonus. And now they get to take 2 free throws. That is a huge play right there.
And the clock stopped.
And only 1 team foul on Phoenix.
Koji, 82% on the season from the foul line.
And Suns have not committed a foul in the last 2 minutes either, so here it is right here. Raptors and the Suns both with 2 timeouts remaining as we go down the stretch. And 1 possession game. Pressure on your 5-on-5 half court. This is big now. The execution, the quality shot.
Barnes up top, flips it back over to Schroeder. Rolling is Poeltl. Here's Scotty. Koji on him. Scotty. The cut. Pascal blocked by Nurkic. Chance here to cut it to 1 or tie it. Under a minute to go. KD with it. Wants a screen. Gets a switch. OG stays with him, in fact. Here's Booker. Shot doesn't go. OG flies in and grabs a rebound.
Easy now. Big trip.
Raptors by 3.
Great leadership from Schroeder and 4th quarter play from Scottie B.
Here's Durant rising up. Achiuwa checked in, gets the rebound, and Schroeder gets fouled.
And remember, they had a foul to give, so now we are still not in the bonus situation here.
Achiuwa's first double-double of the season in his best game this season, doubt, right?
He's brought the lunch pail and a hard hat tonight. His blue-collar effort has been sensational.
Scotty with it, and he's fouled by Eric Gordon.
He wants to get fouled. He's 6-for-6 from the line tonight. He's been one of the elite players in the building tonight, particularly down the stretch.
When you go back to last night, and OG, Scotty, and Pascal shot 30% from the field. You know, not the case tonight. OG, 5 of 10. Pascal, 9 for 21. Scotty, 7 for 15. And really delivered on the second night of a back-to-back. And then on top of that, defensively, all 3 of them were tremendous. 15.9 to go in a 2-possession game.
Phoenix has a timeout remaining, so I'm sure if the second free throw goes, you'll see them advance the ball.
There's a timeout, officials timeout. There's some blood. So Barnes to the free throw line. As you mentioned, 6-of-6, 21 points, 7 rebounds. And we talked about it, about the struggles at the line. The Raptors have been outstanding tonight. One of the reasons why they have this lead, 112-105. Scotty B with a dozen points here in the 4th quarter. Durant, Barnes got a piece of it.
And it's going to be off of Scotty. Phoenix ball, 10.2 to go.
To your point, they've shot 86% from the line tonight.
I mean, this has been as good of a game as you will see up to this point of the season. That's going to do it. Siakam with his ninth rebound. The Toronto Raptors on the second night of a back-to-back, when they didn't arrive until 4 a.m. in the morning, with the Phoenix Suns sitting here waiting for him.
Sizing it up, and he's going to get by Harris. Got there.
But the thing is, De'Anthony Melton is slow on the rotation because the next guy over is C.J. McCollum.
Got Jonas at the high post. Zion's going to beat it himself. Ooh, beautiful dime.
Got it. Gee, that's a dime, bro. Man. That's a dime.
You felt comfortable moving James Harden because of Tyrese Maxey.
Yeah, it was time to give him the keys. Uh-oh.
First. Yeah, uh-oh. Good one. Zion got there.
When Zion catches that ball in the lane.
Got to get rid of it. Deep into the clock now. Zion, see you
later. He got a running start.
And he's going to the
line. He got a running start. Get up, space. And he already had a running start before he even caught that basketball, Joe.
Batum with Marcus Morris. He lost it. He gave it away on his own. Going to his weak hand. CJ on his hesitation. Leaves it off. Good decision.
It's a great pass. It's a great pass. And also just the rhythm. I know what really helped CJ out is when the Pels were in the LA and also in Utah.
But he closed the half. 3+ to play. It's been that good for the Pels. Zion on the handoff. Look at home.
I tell you, and think about Paul Reed. He is not accustomed to guarding somebody like Zion. See, this is simple right here, Joe. This is a simple dribble handoff, but Paul Reed is not accustomed to guarding guys that do that.
We need closed captioning.
Right. This is a family show.
Herb, beautiful pass. Zion! Herb on the beautiful dime. That's 18 assists now.
Like a cornerback and rotating over at the right time. It's a dime right here.
Yeah. Gonna be Herb, corner three. And Najee's there. Back at it. Couldn't finish. And with a clip. Nope. Nice pass.
It's a great pass
nice
by Najee.
Pass. It's close quarters and he gets it done. CJ, great to have him back after missing
yes, it is.
12 games. And Zion for the big guy. Who got shot by Marcus Morris?
That is so difficult to guard. Where only Jonas can get it.
I like the way he's looking for him.
Right.
Sharing it. That's a fifth assist for Zion. By the way, Pels were 5-7. Yeah, come out with the same energy you had. Zion stayed with it. He'll get it, and he's going to the line. They almost took it away.
Right. Really, it's almost like a conscious effort that he's looking for Jonas. Because Jonas is actually open right there, and you know, it's not how you got to find right in the soft spot of the zone. Right there.
Zion's got it.
Right there.
And off the glass.
Yep.
Zion. They hit him in stride. It's going up. End of the shot clock. And underneath. Going to be picked up by Zion. Zion out of the line. He needs it. CJ, sideline trap. And that'll do it. Fouls by a dozen. Jonas up to 19-5. CJ. And nice setup, Jonas. Zion on the finish. Zion is 11 of 11. He's got a season high 32, or make it 33 tonight.
And that knocked him out of the quarterfinals. The pass into Jokic. Had a man, Porter. And Porter fires the three. Good. Good start for Denver. Now Murray around the screen. Bounce it to Jokic. Jokic coming in around Şengün. And he scores it. And now Murray posting up. Over the top he goes. Nope. Jokic rebounds. Pass it out. Porter straight away. Got it again. Michael Porter Jr. Dribble drive in on Green. Give it to Jokic. Extra pass. Holiday for three. Got it. There's some ball handling and some passing by the Denver Nuggets. 17-7 now. KCP, one of his favorite shots, going right at the foul line. And a nice cut through, Murray around the screen, Murray to Jokic, and Jokic drops it in.
It's silky, that's what it is. Jamal Murray with that pocket pass, make it tough on those drives, keep him out of the paint.
Now Jokic against Jock Landale, and Jokic drops it up and in. Landale can't guard Jokic.
No.
Holiday has been very steady. Porter, he's hot. And he nails another one! a Porter quarter for sure. He's got 12 already, and the Nuggets lead balloons to 17.
He did have 10 rebounds on Monday night. Didn't shoot well, but somehow he went to the gym and practiced up a little bit.
He's been shooting the ball well against the Houston Rockets so far this season. But
Jokic in his two games against Houston this year, 36 and 38. And Zeke Nnaji has come off the bench and lays it in. Last year, the Rockets really struggling. Well, this season, 8-7. Jokic, beautiful.
What a fake game, too, on that dribble. He almost held it like he was going to pass it. The dribble was high enough where he could have done that.
Jamal Murray has 3 points so far. Porter, is he still hot? Missed that. Jokic there, and Jokic drops it up and in. Jokic had to get on his tiptoes that time, KD, to get that rebound.
Because he wants to play through it all.
Rockets have made 7 of 14 threes. The pass under it, and great Porter play. Lays it in. Porter's got 14, another assist for Nikola Jokic.
Right here, that area, Michael Porter Jr. sees the defense. They're going to try and switch that, but he's got the switching defender on his high hip. Great read, slips right to the basket, and Nikola Jokic sees him.
Jokic, and Jokic throws it down, his second dunk of the season.
The present and the future, perhaps. And Jokic tapping, put it up and in! Nikola Jokic.
This is my Halloween, and honestly, now we all get to experience it all season long because that's his head shot.
Gotta love it. How about that, Chris Dempsey?
I love every second of that.
It's the most in any half this season.
68 points is the most Houston has allowed in the first half this season as well.
And KCP on the dribble drive, very effective. Şengün is the only Rocket in double figures with 12. On the back cut, Holiday, another beautiful assist by Jokic. Vic, Bill, and Scott on the call. Jokic, long range three, stepped into it nicely. And Joker with his 17th point. Holiday, dump it off to Jokic, and Jokic glides it in. Love what Holiday is bringing to this team. Don't forget, the high school championships are coming to Altitude this Saturday, starting time 11 a.m. Jokic, here he goes again. There he goes again. The Nuggets have 12 to shoot. Now Jokic will fall away. Got it!
It's unguardable. It's unguardable.
Holiday with 6 points. More of a score. What a pass by Jamal Murray. As beautiful a bounce pass as you will see. And Murray. And Jokic has it. Oh, great pass over to Holiday. And he makes it count. Boy, that was almost a handset out to the outside in the volleyball.
Beat on this one, so he just took that foul. But how about that pass right there in the paint? Jamal Murray hitting Nikola Jokic rolling. And Jokic reads the defense so well. Sinking in, kicks it out. Justin Holiday knew he had to knock down that one. And you can't replicate it other than playing in the game. You can't practice. You can't really play 3-on-3. It's not the same.
And Caldwell Pope lights up a three from the right corner.
Season high 38 in the two games against the Rockets, and he's going for another big number tonight. Reggie Jackson missed it. Jokic taps it to himself. Out to Christian Brown for three. Yes! CB.
Cavs have doubled up the Blazers here early. Sharp work in the near perimeter. D.A. pops out, gets the wraparound pass. Money. Attending to him is Mobley, but too late, baby. Feeds to Allen, then gets it back to trigger a three. Up come the Blazers. Brogdon. Good cut, Shea.
It's the same cut he made the play before. This is only going to be the second and third free throws of the entire game.
Jaden Sharp got in deep to the elbow. They're in limited range. He's been working on it.
There's the pull-up. And that's what the Blazers will have to deal with mentally as they continue to try to get over the hump.
Ball moving rapidly for the Blazers for an open shot, and Jaden Sharp knocks down the triple.
There you go. Tumani with a good pass over the top. Jeremy attacks the baseline right after Tumani did. Garland gets wrong. Garland 2-on-1 on that.
Strus, hard slant into the lane. Loops it up, anticipating Grant.
comes free to Sharp, wires a pass to Kamara, in he comes and lays it home.
Hit a head pass from Shea, leading to the bucket for two.
Despite that, they're down eight with possession, and Brogdon going to work. Stifled. Gives to Sharp. A push shot on the run, up and in.
Yep, that's the shot, Kev. That's the pull-up. You ain't got to get all the way to the rim. And then the next time on the left side of the floor, Jeremy was isolating against Jared Allen. That's a tough guy to score over in a one-on-one. There goes Shaden, getting it done on that right wing.
And the Cavaliers building a lead of 14. 5 minutes, maybe 5 minutes gone by. Here's Brogdon on the wing. He drains a triple himself. Screen set up beyond the three-point arc. Rolling is eight. Dribble handoff here to Sharp. Glides in, double pumps and laid it in. Beautiful move.
He chose correctly.
Boot off the screen, stumbles, got balance to the baseline, swings it outside here, Sharp, 11 to shoot. Work it to the baseline, powers up over Garland, clears out Allen with a two-hand jam. Just a chancy pass, flicked in the backcourt. That's a free ball that Scoot will take. Nearly double dribbled, finds Sharp for three, got it! Oh, it didn't look great until it left Sharp's hands, and it's tied at 70 now. Sharp with 19.
Here is when it got good, because now the Blazers have an advantage, 5-on-4. And as Jared Allen loses sight of Shaden, Scoot sees him.
Pinpoint advantage, Cavs as well. Here is Scoot. Great pass inside. Reef lasers one inside to Sharp. Lays it in lefty. Drew the foul and has a chance to head to the line for a three-point play.
It's a lob option for Shaden coming out. The Blazers never got to that part of it, though, because
driving kick. Garland to Strus. Two men running at it. Ball volley. Grabbed by Sharp. Breaks out of backcourt with the dribble. Hands off here to Matisse, trailing for three. Sunk the three-pointer. The Blazers now 7 of 13 shooting from three.
And that last possession for Matisse, he showed you his value on both ends of the floor. Flying for a closeout where he really wasn't even supposed to be the person to get there like that. And then draining a three, and Shaden's in takeover mode. He just hasn't had the same command he normally has each game.
Shaden Sharp's been good here in the second half. A burst into the lane to the glass. Powers it up with the left hand. Shaden Sharp exerting his will.
Shaden gets his drive, gets the step on Strus. And because of how high he jumps and from how far from the rim he's capable of launching, he puts a lot of pressure on a shot blocker like Jared Allen.
Gordon Hayward catch and shoot. All right. Hornets lead 6-0.
Yeah.
Ridges. Bounce pass to Rozier. Terry. Back to Miles. Hornets have hit three three-pointers 3 minutes into our game.
He's one of the best one-on-one players, finds his own space, especially for a young guy. Terry Rozier matches him on the other end.
Cam Thomas forced to give it up. This is Cam Johnson. Terry Rozier coast to coast. Nick Claxton, Cam Johnson. Good defense by PJ to knock it away. Bridges with the right hand.
Yeah.
Nice break. Terry straight on look. Bottom of the well, and the Hornets within one. Here's Nick Smith. Oh my goodness, youngster from Hoboken.
He deserved that. He read that missed shot.
Terry has Finney Smith in front of him. PJ.
Yeah.
First three-pointer for 3J Washington. PJ. Back-to-back threes for number 25.
It's good ball movement side to side.
Rozier. Score the goal.
Oh, yeah. I got to get the ball in the air. He's got to get special attention right away.
Terry Rozier keeps on keeping on. Three for number three. Finney Smith poked away. Hornets ball, 2-on-1. Gordon Hayward! Bounce pass. Mark Williams had it deflected by Sharp, but it's saved. Oh, Miles Bridges knew it. He flicked it over to Terry Rozier before Terry even threw it.
We're seeing them go coast to coast. Nick Claxton with those two buckets like that. You got to stop them from getting inside so early. And then I asked him about just shooting the ball so well. He said it's been ball movement. You see Terry Rozier right there.
Got a result. Shot clock down to four. Oh, look at Terry Rozier. Look at Terry work. Ball fake right. Hezzy. Pump fake. Bridge is right there, but quickly shoots it over the top.
Hornets chance to take the lead. BJ trying to set a screen on Watford. Frees up Rozier. Catches it in for his uniform number. Extra pass to PJ. Terry. That's big. That's what veterans do right there.
No doubt about it. Don't panic.
Terry Rozier, JT Thor, and PJ Washington playing together. And Nick lost it. Able to get it back. This is some sloppiness. This would be pennies from heaven. Oh, my goodness. Chicken salad deluxe.
Scramble, stick a fork in it. PJ says, here, Terry, you take it. This was too high. I really did.
Nine of their last 10 shots, yet they only trail the Nets by three. Hayward way outside. Drives in. Got it to go. 115 to 114. Brooklyn, 20 points for Gordon Hayward. Bridges with Hayward, Sharp, and Williams on the inside. Bridges, off-balance delivery, does it go? Rebound, knocked out of bounds off of Charlotte, so the Nets will retain with 14 to shoot.
And three white jerseys around De'Ron Sharp does a good job working on the inside. Look at him battling for position. He's the only Nets player around there. And he's going to go to the bench now, but gets the ball back for Brooklyn.
Claxton is back in. Nets controlled the paint against Toronto, doing it again tonight. Thomas, in and out. It was halfway down. Hornets trying to grab the lead here. It's Bridges, the corner J, a long-distance connection to put Charlotte in front, 117 to 115. The Nets have missed their last five shots.
And Charlotte shooting 55.9% from three. They're a team that averages 35% from the three-point line, typically.
They need it. They got it. Dodo with a corner three.
It's a big one.
Williams. Wow. Nets wanted to travel. What they get is a missed shot from Williams. 118-117 Brooklyn. Dinwiddie, using that screen from Claxton, uses it again. Zigzag move from Dinwiddie, seven to shoot. Directing traffic, hands to Bridges. Shot clock is down to three. Bridges, hard drive, and finish! Mikal Bridges gets to the cup. Timeout, Charlotte. Some electricity here in this fourth quarter. Cam Johnson got the crowd roaring with a spectacular slam. Nets have made some plays here down the stretch to lead by three. But Charlotte very much in the hunt. Rozier for the tie. He's got it. 120 apiece with 3.5 to go.
And every time Brooklyn makes a nice few offensive possessions, baskets, buckets, you feel like they might be able to create some breathing room, and Charlotte keeps coming up with timely baskets.
He's got 30 points. Terry Rozier. Johnson peeks at the clock. Defended there by Bridges. Johnson lines it up. In and out. Claxton could not finish it. Up ahead. Nice breakup. Free safety. Bridges. 3 minutes to go. Tied at 120. Dinwiddie. Rebounded by Claxton. Dinwiddie. The drive and dish. Claxton waking for the cutter, and it's deflected. Turnover. Washington. Hayward draws defenders. Rozier, the hot hand. He's got another. Terry Rozier for three.
And that penetration and drive collapses the defense. Everyone falls in, and they find the one guy that they want taking the shot.
123-120 Hornets. Bridges. Switch back. Hayward. Seven to shoot. Bridges puts his head down. Fades. Slam down! Johnson on the follow flush.
Big time follow up by Cam Johnson.
29 second chance points. The Nets trail by one. Under 2 minutes to go. Can the Nets stop the Hornets? Can they stop Terry Rozier? Hayward takes the baseline. Over Johnson. It's good. 125-122. Charlotte leads. Bridges for Finney-Smith. Claxton, handoff. Bridges, loop it up. Slam it down! Oh, Clax attack!
It was a great pass. And Bridges got caught because you have Dorian Finney-Smith in the weak side corner. So he wasn't guarding the three-point shot, also not on the inside.
125-124. Hornets in front. A minute 17 to go. Rozier drives. Banker. And a foul called, and that might have been some knee-on-knee action as Bridges was limping, and Rozier is on his back. But it's going to send Scary Terry to the free throw line. First foul on Bridges.
You see.
Yeah.
Yeah. Right knee of Bridges, left knee of Rozier. Of Scary Terry since his Boston days.
It still applies.
Yeah. Tonight in particular.
And they're not missing at the line. 15 of 15. Points. 13 assists. Monster game from Terry Rozier. Charlotte playing without LaMelo Ball. And Rozier knocks down a pair. Nets are down by three. Bridges. Hesitation. Kick. Finney-Smith. Clear it for Dinwiddie. 12 on the clock. Dinwiddie one-on-one with Rozier. Back in. Nets trail by three. Turnaround. Dinwiddie off the window for Spencer Dinwiddie. Cuts it to one. Under a minute to go. Rozier. Switch. That means Dinwiddie is with Williams. Claxton with Rozier. A series of moves. A fade. He's hot. Really hot. Unconscious. Terry Rozier. Timeout Brooklyn. The Nets have allowed just one opponent to shoot better than 50%. It was Miami on November 16th. They shot 51.6%. Hornets are at 51.1%. Get it in. Nets are down by three. 35 seconds to go. Dinwiddie for the tie. It's off. Rebound. Tipped up in the air. Claimed by Claxton. Powers in for two. It's a one-point game. 29.4 on the clock. 20 points. 14 rebounds for Nick Claxton. There's a five-second difference. Shot clock to game clock.
Looks like the Nets are going to just play this straight up.
Rozier, five to shoot. Over Claxton, no good. The Bucks out by Finney-Smith. Nets are down by one. 3 seconds, 2 seconds. Johnson, no good. Charlotte holds on for the win. Nets had a clean look, could not convert.
First of a back-to-back for the Knicks. They will take on the Raptors in Toronto tomorrow night. Brunson on the fade.
I'll be hanging with Kenny tomorrow night, folks.
Jalen Brunson off to an outstanding. RJ Barrett heading home. Grew up in nearby Mississauga, Ontario. Here's Brunson from behind the arc. Jalen Brunson. Thanks, Rebecca. A very happy 29th to Julius.
Yep, coming off his best game ever, the 2020 efforts.
On cue, Randall from three. Here's Brunson. Jalen Brunson knocks it down. Scored 23 against Charlotte on Tuesday night. Brunson from three.
Popping in the air. We'll watch Brunson stopping and popping. Last season he attempted four.
3-point Knick lead. They've led by as many as seven. Brunson, another three. Who's 3 of 3 from downtown.
Richard Hart coming off his best game of the season, the last game. Randall also.
Brunson from three. Knicks now with Brunson, DiVincenzo, Hart. Brunson from three and the foul.
Baffled and befuddled and devastated as Brunson's looking for the 4-point opportunity being hacked and whacked behind the arc.
Jalen Brunson leading the way for the Knicks tonight. Picks up where he left off in the first half. Brunson. Here's Barrett from three. Robinson, offensive rebound.
Yeah, Durham not blocking him out.
Brunson gets the roll.
Never saw this coming, the way the Knicks open the game. Especially Brunson. Oh.
Brunson. There's Randall from three. Knicks back up by three.
Brunson dishing and swishing. And they're looking to run against the Knicks, so the Knicks have to get back.
Sasser with 15 points off the bench, 5 threes. Brunson, Randall, and Barrett Klein have scored all but 10 of the Knick points tonight. There's Brunson, banks it in. 35 for Jalen Brunson.
Yep, right at their season's average. Watch Brunson off the glass, folks. The creativity. Serendipity that time for the Pistons and Cunningham.
Hart from three. His first points tonight. Scoreboard had it at 86 for a moment. There's Brunson. 37 points for Jalen Brunson. Brunson picks up the dribble. Five on the shot clock. Hart takes it inside. Good ball movement by the Knicks. DiVincenzo from three.
Timely hooping tonight by Devo. Grandeur, the splendor of the three ball. Knicks swishing and dishing now from behind.
Brunson pulls it back out. Defended by Ivy. Now Cunningham on Brunson. DiVincenzo, his fourth three.
And a little deja vu this time. It's shorted.
Got to throw it up there. Hope he's out again. Hold on.
Oh, saved. And the Pacers have it. Here's Halliburton for three.
What a really good pass by Brown. Oh, they've got to advance the ball. And, I mean, you got to move it forward. Ooh, a deep three.
He was on Halliburton. He was on the K of Kaseya. Halliburton at the line, 92% on the year. He's eighth in the league. He is top 15 in four categories. It tells you the start he's had. Fort takes a break as Benedict Mathurin is in for the first time, and also in Aaron Nesmith. 8 points for...
Getting that second win is going to be important for him.
Mathurin goes right by his defender, and it's a blow-by.
It's a great record. Here's what I liked about that. That you didn't have Halliburton feel like he had to be the one to push it. He just ran it up the court.
And Toppin right to the basket.
And that's the third layup the Pacers have gotten. It's really not on the catch because he never really caught it.
Hawkins picked up his second foul. There's Halliburton right to the basket. He's in double figures.
It's the fourth one, yeah. Chris. They're trying to get Love in it so he can turn the corner on Love. Love was never a great defender. Really tough shot. Going left, a little runner. I think maybe availability, but effectiveness for him.
And Halliburton has 30. And Miami advancing all the way out of the play-in. And here's the alley-oop. Halliburton to Toppin.
I mean, that's an instance, Chris, where Jimmy Butler is trying to make sure his teammate has some success so you can get him to play defense on the other end. Ball movement, Halliburton.
Tyrese with his third three.
Great hands by Hey, Halliburton just did a heck of a job. They doubled, and he did a heck of a job of getting his hands up into the passing lane. Got the dunk.
Pacers forced the turnover. They've scored 9 points off errors by Miami. Halliburton has 18 in the first half. With a 6-point lead, 60-54. Halliburton front court takes it all the way up and
that's
in.
Yeah, I think that Highsmith got him. You'll see right here, just see, Marquez didn't know what he was wanted to do, and it's too late. What I like about it is Halliburton at the rim, because that's not what OB does. So what Miami's decided to do, Chris, is just continue to drive. You, buddy, for Halliburton.
Wow.
Tyrese comes down and is able to, Highsmith can't get their time. Now, mind you, Highsmith's got to be 6'6".
Final 90 seconds plus of this first half, a half that the Pacers have never trailed. Here's a step back three. Halliburton again.
Oh, shoot it again on him. Tie. Tyrese comes down and is able to, Highsmith can't get their time. Now, mind you, Highsmith's got to be 6'6", 6'7" himself.
26 first half points, 9 of 13 from the field, 5 of 8 from three. And now a message from Mr. Quick.
Okay, Toppin is out there. But if you look at Miami, they've got all guards on the floor.
Kinds of coverages in the second half on him.
Yeah, especially in this building with their coaching staff and the players they have over there. They got a lot of tricks up their sleeves, so we got to be prepared, ready for that first hit coming out of halftime and try to sustain it, not turn the ball over and play our game.
There's a turnover. This is what Halliburton and his teammates, and particularly Toppin, that's his best attribute.
Late in the first half, Halliburton had a 28-point first half, most he's ever had in the first 24 minutes of a game, and now he's got 30 and a foul.
Terrific read here by Halliburton, seeing that there really is no help, and he's able to put that up. Oh, they let that go. Good.
Yeah, I thought it might be goaltending.
I did, too. They felt that was still going up.
Toppin for three. That is a huge possession.
So those are the kind of things that Coach Eric Spoelstra has to deal with. I am telling you.
Again, the cookie jar with the foul.
Our audio crew is excellent, but I don't know if we want to pick up that much of the whistle.
To start the fourth quarter, Halliburton stays out there. He's out there with Heel, Brown, Turner, and Mathurin. Go. Buddy for three.
Worked out perfect. And that play with Roquez was because Mathurin lost him.
Halliburton gets inside.
Get a teardrop.
And he got it.
Yeah, just get a teardrop. Somebody got it. They got him out of where he needed to be, but he still wasn't able to make a shot.
Halliburton hits.
And you see Cole right now. He knows that he doesn't feel like anybody on the floor from the Pacers. He doesn't feel like most of the people in the league can guard him, quite frankly. It makes it awful hard. You get fouls on you that you don't normally get. And that's what happened here with Nesmith. They allowed him to play when Butler was out getting a rest. Remember how tight Butler was when he was gone.
Buddy for three, got it. Just 1 of 10.
These guys have to get in their mind, Chris, the Pacers, that you've got to be better defensively. This team, the Miami Heat, a team typically in the, you've got to get it in your head. You got to do a better job on the defensive end. And I know that the staff is working tirelessly.
Martin nearly stolen, taken by Heel. Halliburton has 44.
Yeah, Rick had to call one when all of a sudden Miami was going on a run.
Halliburton gets to the basket, scores, and a foul. He's got 46.
Yeah, they put it. Got going. And he does a good job getting through there.
Rebound to Highsmith. Lowry on a hit ahead for Jimmy. Pacers are back. Butler converts. Draws a second defender. Opens things up for Duncan. Sends it back to Jimmy. Oh, the paint attack for Butler. The Heat were patient, got just what they wanted. First five shots, has the Pacers up a dozen. He has a dozen. Jimmy, a one-hander. Jimmy Butler with an 8-point first quarter. That's Miami's counterpuncher right there. Heat down by six. Butler got fouled by Heald. It bounces in.
By Jimmy, getting to the left hand, gets Heald on his back. That's a great seal. Then when he takes the contact, able to get the ball up, gives it an opportunity and one there for Jimmy Butler. Been to the free throw line.
Jimmy, left wing against Halliburton, against a triple team. Able to score, and another foul. Three-point play.
Yeah, slowing the game down, using his power on top of Halliburton there. Look at the different jerseys trying to get in the play there.
In Chicago, here in Miami, it's 92-82 Indiana. Butler shakes free and slams.
Great cut by Jimmy Butler.
Oh, the great footwork. No finish, though, this time. Love gets the offensive board into Jimmy. A 12-point quarter for Butler. Heat ball, and the Heat lead by seven. In the Jimmy, got the layup. Got inside of Bruce Brown. Fourth quarter.
And playing with great pace, cutting hard. Jimmy Butler catches it over the top from K. Love.
Shot clock at eight.
Oh, Duncan's got to look for a layup there.
Jimmy flips it up and in. Jimmy Butler with a six-point fourth quarter.
Not forced.
Right.
Come with the flow. Here is Young. Hawks. Back to their superstar, Trey Young. The Spurs have hit seven of their first eight. Young. Deep three is not a problem. Capella had it swiped away. Nice move. Branham. Sohair with a stop. To the game. 34% from three. 27th in the league. But tonight, good open looks, and they are falling. The other way, same thing can be said that time.
Here is Young.
Up for the left hand, is not afraid to go deep to the rack.
Little guys trying to challenge Victor in the paint area, they find out. Leads to an easy break.
Bogdanovich answers with a three of his own. Young again. This movie before, too many times. But the Spurs quickly answer to regain the lead is Sohan. Okay, folks, quick. You remember George Viking? Oh. Sohan! You remember that? As the Spurs putting on a dunk shot.
Zach's doing a nice job running that high post.
Bogdanovich for three. Well, we told you it'd be entertaining and offensive-minded.
Cross-court pass from Trey.
Young gives it up. Hunter knocks it down for three. The Hawks coming in, shooting 36.8 from three. Kelvin spots Sohan for three. And nothing but the bottom of the net. Sohan. Hawks 7 of 14 from distance.
Jeremy put in a lot of work on that shot this summer. You can tell it's a lot better than it was last year. Records if he stays there.
Vassell to Sohan. Eight on the shot. Jeremy with a little hook.
Well, Jeremy get a chance to show off when he played for the Pistons. So he can score. Anybody that's put a 50 in an NBA game can put the ball in the basket.
Fourth-year play out of Villanova. Sohan trying to take over. And Jeremy with the dunk. Young, great pass inside. Yeah. Leads to the dunk.
Well, like I said, he's a brilliant passer. There's no question about it. Oh, my net shot to get up on the Hawks right now. Let me try to go two for one in this half, and that's what I'm talking about. Yeah.
Young, and that's only going to leave. Losing to Boston in seven or six games in that opening round. Capella gets loose here.
They just haven't gotten a good shot, and you know, Victor was open there for a lob. I see how patient Trey Young is there. He's waiting for somebody to step up and stop him.
Away.
Watch this here. I mean, he doesn't want to take on Victor, but as soon as Victor makes his move back to his man, the glass is wide.
And UW up in Seattle before coming in with the Spurs in 2016, the number 29 pick.
Another testament to hard work. And remember, when he got here, he said he didn't know that there was a proper way to shoot the ball.
Fourth time we've been tied. Sohan getting nifty inside.
Yeah, and that's what he's got to do more of there, Billy.
Wendy with 16. There's
Young, crafty, and that will count. One and a chance for a four-point play. Jump the foul. Look at this.
Well, because he takes the right angle. I mean, he immediately puts Malachi on his back. Doesn't allow him back in the play.
Foot on the line? Oh, yes. It should be a two. Yeah, and they've already overruled it. That is a two. First bucket of the night for Malachi, along with two boards and two assists. Young drills a three, and the Hawks knotted at 81. Fortune didn't turn it over there. Jeremy Sohan lines up a three. Yes, sir!
Down low where Jeremy's got a smaller guard posted up, and Jeremy Sohan continues to fill it up.
Young in a push shot, and an and one. Spurs can't connect on that three. They've hit 13 tonight on 28 shots from deep. Young continues to pound away.
As a rookie, he's just gotten better and better.
Young again.
He almost wanted to take the ball out of his hands.
Yeah.
It's a two for one, so I'd be surprised if he gives this one up.
Everybody in the building. First miss from the line. Spurs with a 5-point edge. A wide open there. Nice pass. Okongwu gets the bucket.
Trey Young pass. I mean.
Through Kelvin's leg. 14 of 31.
Victor just went for the reach there. He's not able to get it.
15 points from deep. Bogdanovich from Young.
That shot was from Floresville.
Whoa. Again, nice slick pass inside and an and one for the Hawks again. Get that breather.
Yeah.
Collins, Vassell, Sohan, Champagne, and Johnson. There's Jeremy.
And that's the benefits of having a big point guard. Jack Collins over the top to Jeremy Sohan. And Jeremy does a nice job just keeping DeJounte. He's been picking on DeJounte and Trey Young a little bit tonight.
Season best 24 for him as Young gets number 36. Bogdanovich the other way. They got a 4-on-1. Young, Bogdanovich over Collins.
Wow.
Timeout Spurs. Rebound Wembanyama. Pops in, push it. Up in transition. Sohan attacks. But missed that one.
And again, that's how you run that break or a little mini break.
He's giving it up to Jones. Wembanyama swings it. Sohan finishes it. Oh, brother.
It's going to happen. Beautiful extra pass. Jeremy Sohan with a little extra mustard on that one. Oh, he's kicked that one right in the stand.
Throw in Champagne's 15 off the bench. Turn it to it.
Unfortunately, offense hasn't been the problem for our guys.
No.
Trey Young has.
And then Capella with a slam dunk to give the Hawks another 2-point lead.
It's extremely well executed. Beautiful no look there by Trey Young.
Sohan outside, deflected. Jeremy. Throws it up, got fouled with 9 on the shot clock as he goes into the Hawks bench.
A major part.
I thought that was 5.
I was going to say, if he was 5,
yeah, he's
leaving him out there on the floor.
Not bad. Sohan. He's just tied his career high with 30. He had 30 against Phoenix last season. And he ties the game, most importantly. Young fouled on his way to the basket once again. They are now 19 of 22 from the line. And Young pours in two more. Oh, 38 for Young. Collins, 3:11 remaining. Back to Sohan. Vassell.
6 on the shot clock. Sohan on the drive, swings it. Wemby couldn't come up with that one.
Just outside of his reach. You turn that corner, go to attack the basket. When the defender steps up, then you toss it up there.
Spurs trying to get out of his hands, and he does, as Young finds Capella for another dunk. Spurs trying to snap a 12-game losing streak. Down by 4 with 2:32 to go. Vassell, strong to the hole, and then gives it up, and another turnover. And the Hawks trying to take control in the final 2:19.
You see the poise that they show here. It's not a crazy shot. They had numbers, but they didn't like it. You bring it back out.
Sohan trying to come up with Murray. 3 on the shot clock. Murray. Rebound, Keldon Johnson. Off to Sohan. 2 minutes to go. He's fouled. No call. Kicks it out. Vassell. Got it! 1-point game.
Boy, that had turnover written all over it. They got a 3-ball out of it.
And Devin Vassell with 25. He's 4-10 from 3. Spurs hit 17 threes.
But again, how do you stop this man with the ball?
Young letting it wind down. Capella with a screen. Deflected. Bogdanovich. Murray for 3. Big shot over Zach Collins from the former Spur. 4-point game. Murray with 24. Sohan gives it up inside, and Collins lays it in.
Great cut there by Zach. Good patience from our guys. Again. But it comes down to this side of the floor.
33 assists on 46 field goals for the Spurs. But stops, as Sean mentioned, is what they've got to have. Young just flicks it up off the glass. 59 seconds to go.
No 3-balls.
Yeah, everything in the paint. In fact, almost in the circle. Wembanyama. Couldn't get it to go, and the Hawks get it back up 4 with 52 seconds to go.
Yeah, I'll get up apply a little pressure here. I mean, Trae Young is going to take his time, and he's going to milk the clock.
Sohan doing what he can. Young. Oh, got the call there. My. Trae Young making it 133 to 128. And now the Hawks' largest lead here with just 39 seconds to go.
Knock out the word forced.
Yeah.
I don't want to say they forced 20 turnovers. I think, you know, we just shot ourselves in the foot there.
Collins is fouled. Into the game. Spurs desperately need to try to get a turnover. Put some pressure here, and Quinn Snyder will take a timeout.
Guy off the screen at full speed, or a big guy needs to step up and help. And just, you know, situational things where maturity really counts.
Johnson fouls Young in the backcourt. His career high is 56. Back to a two-possession game. He just tied. Jones. Sohan. Hits the corner 3 under pressure. 18 seconds to go, but they get the ball into Trae Jones
immediately.
At 33, as Young goes right back to the free throw line. Atlanta has 1 remaining. A miss. Wembanyama bringing it quickly. He fires a 3. Johnson. Keldon lays it up and in with 6 seconds to go. They'll have to foul immediately. Timeout. Snyder uses final timeout here.
Oh, you got to keep it out of Bogdanovich's hands as well.
Wembanyama shattered him. Oh, it's a steal. Jeremy Sochan going to the hole. A whistle and an offensive foul on Jeremy Sochan. Yes, that is the call. Spurs do not have a challenge remaining because they don't have a timeout. Here's the look.
Oh, great steal there. And Trae Young's waiting on him.
2.7. And that'll do it. Wow. Hawks survive.
Shea got caught on the baseline. Now trying to bounce off of Christie. Christie hasn't seen him yet, and Shea able to slip right around the mounds.
Second time he's done that, folks.
Giddey's wide open, and he'll put that one in. The Thunder have had three wide open. And that becomes a five-point swing when Shea, usually reliable with those layups, didn't get it. LeBron on the other end getting wide open underneath. Nice find, Shea. 9 in December. December 30th. Shea, step back shot, and he splashes it in. And Shea's got a Thunder three. Shea, he's got a little step back in his bag. Thunder did a good job of limiting Christian Wood there. Shea got around the screen, pulls up right over Wood. There is SGA, just so much under control. A ton, but that foul for SGA surrenders free throws.
Yeah, just smooth. Just trying to get a wide open shot in the NBA, you have to take it no matter who it is.
Prince all over SGA, and he had enough to get that up over the rim. Porter, Holmgren, and Dort are going to come back in.
Well, good job of just staying focused on that shot right there. You know the Lakers are going to come off this hot shooting. They got a great start here in this first quarter. You just got to keep playing ball.
Points. SGA with 11 as we're under a minute to go. SGA making his move on Prince. That time he got fouled. Prince a little late on the closeout. Opportunity for three.
How about this little stop and pop action? And there's Prince right there easily. Easy call for the official. As he comes down, folks, wasn't his landing space. That's what guys can contribute.
Six out of his first seven. Christie got down low. Now he's tied up, and Shea just too much strength ripped it away. It's a three on one. SGA is going to keep it himself, go right at Reeves and bank it home. To keep SGA in front of him. And here's SGA's defense. He leads Michael the NBA at over two steals a game.
And you love this, too, because this is Thunder basketball.
You see him at times, he'll return back to that all-star form. He hasn't been an all-star in 2 years, but he's had some really low games. And Holmgren returns the favor on the other end, goes right at him. Brown pass. And SGA did not use the screen, but still knew where Chet Holmgren was going to be.
How about getting it right back to him?
From three prior to that attempt, is now 3 for 11. That is something that has really dropped in his game over the last 3 years. Shea inside, he's going to get the whistle, and he's going to go to the line for his second three-point play of the game. Thunder just continued to apply pressure on the Lakers. Shea, a big part of that, stops, pulls up, tough shot fading away. Not a problem, got it up over Reeves. You said, Michael, all these different Lakers.
Two, and they've slowed it down like they're doing now when they need to.
Shea probing, going to work, spinning, hanging in the air. And he spun right around Reeves for another tough finish. Physically, it was obviously at a point two coming out of halftime with Dave Bliss with Paris. His physical, tall team of the Lakers, but SGA didn't look like there was a whole lot going on there. Happy with the call.
This is a great defense. Great defense by LeBron James. And Shea, you know, he's not going to let you get out of here.
Run some clock now. Run some clock.
With 100 seconds to go, Kobe White to Vucevic. The kick. Dosunmu saved it to Caruso. And needs help. White resets with four. Two on the clock. Kobe White. Step back. They won nights like tonight, which isn't over, by the way, but still a minute 26 to go. We know what Dame Lillard has done at the United Center in key moments late. Broke the hearts of the Bulls a few years ago with the Blazers with a furious comeback. Lillard to Giannis, and he jams it in again. Great two-man game with those two. They haven't had their typical scoring nights. Remember, each of them had 30-plus three straight games coming in. And they've combined for 40 on just 28 shots. A minute to go. Bulls trying to pull off what probably is considered a shocker tonight. White driving, kicking, not a good pass. Yeah. Beasley knocks it out.
He read that. He read that perfectly. He dropped that in the coverage that time because he knew Kobe was going to throw it back. Smart play by Beasley. Watch this. He's going to trail. Now watch. He knows he's going to throw it back. He just steps back in there. Almost came up with the steal.
Rodney Mata wipe off the ball. 3.8 remains on the shot clock. Caruso will trigger the inbound. Trying to make it a three-possession game with a basket. Vucevic couldn't get it. Here comes Giannis. It's Beasley. Up three. Big one again for Malik Beasley. His third of the quarter. Ben Taylor will call a timeout. They're going to make sure they add an extra second onto the clock. With the turnover late in the shot clock and the big three by Beasley.
This is a big possession right here for the Bulls.
Bulls can go 2-for-1 here. White. Vooch on the drive. Back to White. Open three. Kobe White though, but tipped out of bounds. It is Bucks ball. I wasn't sure if Lillard touched it or not. It is Milwaukee basketball.
Right,
32 seconds.
Shake it off.
Yep.
Let's get a stop. You still got the lead.
This is the possession of the night. Again, you want to win games with a rocky season, it's going to have to be at this end of the floor against one of the best offensive teams in the game.
It runs another two-man game.
It's Lillard on the drive. Lillard the kick. Big Brook Lopez with a three to give the Bucks the lead. His fifth three of the second half.
Oh, my goodness.
Football game tonight. Shot clock is off. Let's see how late the Bulls go down in the clock here. Down by one. Here's Dosumu.
That's some greens.
Ayo, shut off. On the drive, Williams caught by Giannis.
Oh, man.
Oh, he just stopped the drive of Williams with 6 seconds left. Giannis Antetokounmpo, wow. The former defensive player of the year.
That was a big-time block. That was a big-time block right there. That was big-time. Good back cut. And then Giannis comes over with the right hand and blocks it. 5 blocks on the night.
And Adrian Griffin with Bulls playing well defensively on that inbound. Has to call the timeout. Bulls still down by 1. 6 seconds left. The timeout advances the ball to the front court. They throw it to the backcourt for Giannis. And he gets fouled. That's a big one there to make it a 2-point lead. All right, 3-point game, so there's the timeout.
Time to get a good shot into the Bulls.
Milwaukee does not have a foul to give. Vucevic. Caruso. Alex Caruso to tie the game. White thought he should have had the steal on Lillard. There's the double on Giannis again. Everybody rotating. Beasley gets a nice clean look for the deuce. Time. Pulls down 2. White, a little step back over Lopez again.
That shot right there.
Giannis cuts to the rim and off the inbound. Lillard continues to make plays. What you and I were talking at the break, this guy has acclimated himself to Milwaukee in no time.
Well, he makes basketball plays.
Yep.
You know, he's got 11, 12 assists.
That's a good basketball play. Great play. 6 for Beasley. It's Lillard with Vucevic on him. They get it to Lopez. Go super right.
To a two-possession game if the Bulls can score here.
Here's Vucevic. Driving, spinning, shooting, and drawing a foul. In all aspects of the offense. A big free throw make there.
Plus 10 on rebounds.
Vucevic, a season high. 29 points. thing for the Bucks. Nine-man rotation. Caruso the steal. And he's going to run clock, find Williams.
Come on, fly with me. Patrick Williams did block this.
Giannis stuffed him at the end of regulation. This time, Williams puts him up seven. Lillard fires a three. That's no good. Giannis the rebound. Beasley's got it. Can't get the shot off. Lopez will take a deep three and knock it down. His sixth three of the night.
They got a foul.
10 seconds left, down four, and there's a foul by Giannis on White.
Well, that looked like a football foul.
Yeah, Giannis made sure that White was okay. I think even he knew he got a little aggressive.
Oh, first and 10.
15-yard penalty, automatic first down. Caruso the steal. And a good wait, good patience to get it to Williams.
He's going to pull it out and wait for the traffic to come through, and then he's going to find Patrick Williams flying to the rim.
Smart
play. Nice basketball play. Again, player with a high basketball IQ, understanding the situation. You don't need to rush in and take the shot. If something presents itself, I can make that pass ahead, I'll do it. Other than that, pull it back out. They got a foul. This is a huge win for the Bulls. They needed this win. They needed this in a bad way.
Five-game losing streak. Lost eight of their last nine. All the tumult around the team. And
no fouls. No fouls into the Bulls right now. You're up five in a two-possession game. You don't want them to score quick, though.
Oh, Lillard was trying to draw the foul. Hit the deck hard. Nearly a five. Williams knocks it away. Patrick Williams hit the exclamation point.
Don't fly with Patrick.
This is as angry, animated, and emotional as I've seen Patrick Williams in his time in Chicago. And Kobe White had to make sure he didn't hang on the rim. Bulls win.
Drive home safely, Chicago.
Every once in a while, you do need a reminder of how special and legendary, like, you know, us three have been, you know, these 12 years. All the teammates that we've played with over the course of the journey, and honestly, kind of let you smile a little bit to, you know, look ahead at the challenge that's in front of us to, you know, maintain that winning kind of expectation. So it's all of it is really, really dope.
It's very rare in pro sports that you get to be teammates with guys for over a decade. And we've done some pretty historic things together. We're not satisfied, but when you're going to look, hopefully when our careers are done, you look back on what we were able to do, you can say it's one of the better trios to play in the NBA. So just to be even in that conversation with some of the greatest ever play is incredibly cool. And I'm a big basketball historian, and, you know, to look at us three and think that we've won championships, you know, in the same realm as guys like McHale, Bird, and Parrish, or Manu, Tim, and Tony. Hopefully Steph, Clay, and Dre will leave a legacy like they did.
Oh, man, it's an incredible feeling, blessing to play with two guys like that for 12 years. The success we've had is great. The downs we've had is great. You know, they bring us closer and we stick together through those. The journey has been incredible. Very thankful to our organization for making this happen. I think, you know, most people get their flowers when they die. Like, in our case, it wouldn't be dying, but you get your flowers after you're done. You know, and for the organization to honor us and make it a point. Like, we didn't have to have a game today, you know, just to make it a point to get it done. Very appreciative. You know, it's a great night, great moment. But a lot more work to be done.
The luxury to have that kind of offensive spacing.
Celtics lead the league in made threes. Beverly able to hit over the outstretched arm of Horford.
Dave, those are great shots, right? The quality, there's nobody within 5 feet of these guys, and that's why they keep shooting them.
Paul Reed able to connect from outside.
So sometimes that takes longer, so you can build off that. And look, it doesn't make sense. They're ninth offensively. That doesn't make sense. They're going to figure it out. Sometimes the offensive rhythm is Beverly gets to the rim.
Miyakata knocking down both free throws, and Boston leads by 6, 32-26. Covington drills a three. That's his second triple. I mean, they're shooting 75% overall from the floor here in the first quarter. And 6 of 8 from 3, 75% as well. Beverly, only a three-point lead, though. Philadelphia shooting 57%. Beverly and Melton with 9 points apiece. Beverly reverse layup, giving him 11, pulling Philly within one.
He's encouraging that. Great cut by Reed.
Brown gets to the basket, but misses. Philly on the run. Harris in transition. Gets the layup. Philly has made 7 of its last 8 shots from the floor and grabs a 1-point lead. But just 19 here in the second quarter. Beverly blows right by Holiday and gets the floater. Beverly with 13 points in this game.
It's these 2-for-1 possessions. It's fine to get a quick shot up, but it's totally a good shot.
That's a good shot for Beverly the last 3 games. Maybe not always, but it's falling tonight and this week for Pat Beverly.
Here, he's been hot. I every player is hot. Beverly, he's knocking down every.
Embiid and Maxey both out due to illness. Second straight game, Embiid's missed. First for Maxey this year is Patrick Beverly, an offensive machine here today.
8 of 9.
Philly at 12-6, 0-2 without Embiid. Bamba for 3, got it. Mo Bamba,
yeah, big shot, big shot. The first shot, second shot was okay, but the first one, that's just a tough shot.
He's taken 10 more shots than the next guy. As Bamba ties the game with a 3.
Bamba giving him a nice boost here, right? He's 2 threes in a row in a game like this, a tight game, keeping him in it.
That's 16 turnovers by the Celtics. Covington got it. Every time it looks like Boston might pull away, Philly comes back with a big hit. Heat is 5 for Boston. Been a long time since the Celtics have had a 5-point lead. Largest lead for them was 8. Largest deficit was 7. There's Beverly. And he puts it up and in with the floater. He's got 22 points.
That's his signature shot right there, that running floater. It's a tough shot, but he's practiced it, and he can make that shot. Makes it quite a bit.
Horford off the screen, gets the pitch back. He'll try a 3. In and out for Horford. Horford had 2 early threes. He's got 16 points on the night. Now you got Holiday, great on-ball defender, working on Morris. And he'll switch now out to Beverly. Morris, smaller defender on him. Here comes the help. Shot clock down to 3, so Beverly goes down the lane. Missed it. Batted out. And Harris tracks it down. And a fresh 14 seconds. And calling violation on Tobias Harris.
Yeah, he's frustrated. I mean, great job by the Sixers all night, crashing the glass. They were trying to attack that miss. You know, like I said, he just helps you win games. He's been doing it for a long time.
He was huge 2 weeks ago in the Boston win in Philly. Had 27 points in that game. He's got 21 tonight. Holiday turns it over. Harris with a transition opportunity. Drives past 2 defenders and got it blocked. Out of bounds, though, off of Boston. Harris arguing with Nick Booker.
Yeah, see the replay of this if we can, but he didn't like it. I mean, I do think there was some contact here. Maybe didn't warrant a foul, but there was a couple guys, Derek White, both great players at the rim, but no, I didn't. Unless they got him in the back. Didn't look like a ton. Maybe right there with that left hand, Brown, but
a little bit of a push in the back, but not enough for Booker to call.
That can mess you up, though. That can. I mean, you get a little tiny nudge in the back, and it can really throw you off.
Philly down 3, inside 4 minutes to go. Harris, after a 5-for-7 start, now 6 of 16 from the floor. And he's had his shot blocked 3 times here in the fourth quarter. Beverly penetrates. Little out of control. Lost it, but they're going to call a foul on Boston. That's the 14th foul.
It's not pretty in the half court right now for the Sixers. But you know what? Look, this lineup has never, these guys have never played together. Beverly's not used to being this usage guy. They're putting him on the ball. But look, they're in the game. They're in the game. They score here, cut it to 1, maybe tie it up with a 3.
DeAnthony Melton fouled out. Philadelphia did not have Embiid, Maxey, or Batum at all tonight. Tatum got ejected at the end of the third with his second technical. Shot clock at five. Porzingis out tonight. Beverly knocks down another three to tie the game. Beverly with 22 points. Make it 25 after the three.
I'm surprised Pritchard was sat down. They sat Pritchard down and brought Cornette in. They're going right at Cornette. That's a smart play by Beverly. Cornette is not comfortable out there in space.
Pull-up jumper. Jaylen Brown is on the money. It's the mid-range shot to put the Celtics back in front by two.
Watch if they attack Cornette again, because that's the weakness right here in the Celtics defense in the half court. This is what they want right here, this isolation. But White's not leaving. They're going to play go attack here with Morris. It's...
Degree of difficulty very high there. Morris got it to go over two defenders.
But Cornette, this is not the Celtics team. They're missing Tatum and Porzingis. But this great job by Philly staying in this one.
Here's Derek White. Defender leaves him, takes the shot, missed it, and Beverly knocked to the ground by Cornette. He's going to have free throws on the other end as both teams are in the penalty with 2:28 to go.
Playing in a while, they went right at him.
Beverly gives Philadelphia a one-point lead, and it will be Cornette going to the bench with Pritchard back on the floor.
Tobias at the five, and that's a small lineup.
Beverly missed the second one. Rebound by White. 2:25 remaining. Boston down one. Remember, the Celtics have not lost at home this season. And they've been blowing teams out here by 152 points in eight home games. Horford driving. Middle of the lane. Shot clock at six. Horford up and in. Off the glass. Boston back up by one with two to play.
He knows nobody can bother him down there. He's confident. There's no shot blocking. Not a lot of true fives. If even any shot blockers down there for Philly, he went right at it for the easy layup.
These teams will meet one more time at the end of February. The winner of this game will take a 2-1 lead. Could be a tiebreaker at the end of the year should these teams be tight. Missed three by Covington. Rebound Brown.
Great closeout by Horford. Made that shot a tough shot for Covington.
Brown, and they're going to call a foul here on the floor on Beverly, but it looked like there was contact by Jaylen Brown. Now, Nick Nurse already used his coach's challenge and did not have a successful challenge. So that's it. Well, Two shots for Brown because they're in the bonus.
Well, I don't think Bill Kennedy thinks Beverly, that was an acting job, I suppose. You got to see the replay, but Beverly, he can't do anything about it at this point, but he snapped his head back.
Brown connects on the first free throw. Take a look here to see if Beverly did try to sell.
I mean, I don't think it's as bad as Beverly said, but it's not nothing. But I think Beverly got him there early, and they just called the first foul, I suppose.
Jaylen Brown, the mid-range jumper a moment ago, and now two made free throws to push the lead to three with a minute 30 remaining here in the game.
Watch Bamba here. He could free him up. I mean, Horford doesn't probably want to get out there too far.
Bamba has knocked down 2 3-pointers here in the second half. Covington has it knocked away, but Beverly's there to clean it up. And now Beverly puts it on the deck. Covington out of control. Pulling the chair out is Holiday. Offensive foul call on Covington.
Holiday made that possession. I mean, his defense there, moving his feet. Done it so many times, just kind of blowing up the whole possession, switching at the right time, and making game-winning plays. I mean, just watch this. Jumps the screen right here. Right position. Covington, travel, offensive foul, whichever one you want.
A lot of times you talk about getting players for big offensive moments late in games. Holiday is a guy that can give you big defensive moments.
Yeah, both him and Derek White, two of the best perimeter defenders in the entire NBA.
Great pickup by the Celtics, getting Holiday. Shot clock at 10. Horford penetrates and kicks. Now Holiday down the lane. And another foul call on Beverly trying to block the shot. He didn't like it, but Holiday will shoot two.
But you can't go on the guy's forearm. Anyways, I don't mind him. He competes.
Big free throw made there by Holiday to push it to a two-possession game. And Nick Nurse will take a timeout. That will lead us and some clutch defense, drawing a charge on Beverly, or on Covington, rather, on the last possession.
Yeah, when Melton fouled out, Dave, we knew it was going to be tough for Philly to get quality looks in the half court. And clearly, Boston, Pritchard back in the game. The defense has been better than it was with that short stretch with Cornette.
Philadelphia, though, has answered every big shot by Boston. Can they do it again? Timers at eight. Beverly, step back three over Horford. No good. Rebound, Pritchard. Philly will not foul. Shot clock at eight. White drives. Out to Horford. Shot clock at three. Holiday sees it. Fires to Pritchard underneath. Puts it in.
Great look, great job by Pritchard finding that opening. Great cut, great finish.
An 8-0 run by Boston to take a 7-point lead. Celtics got to rush it. Morris cans a three. They're still down two possessions. They got to foul Horford.
For a team in Boston, they average 19-point victories margin in 8 home games. So quite a job by Philly to hang in there.
When Pritchard was on the floor for a good part of that fourth quarter, he was terrific. 10 big points in the quarter. He had not scored the first three quarters. His teammates stepped up. Brown, Holiday, White, Pritchard, and Horford all with big moments here in the fourth quarter as Harris.
I guess you make these two.
And they don't have a timeout. They can't
advance. Yeah, they have timeouts.
Yes.
And if they foul Boston, they do it. Now you.
Cornette with a rebound.
Do it.
And fouled. Or no, didn't foul him. That's it. Well, it was not easy against a heavily undermanned Philadelphia team.
The rim to grab that hard pass.
Podziemski for three. It's a big one. 105-99. The rookie delivers again. He has 10 off the bench.
Think about it, Brian. He's out on the floor with just over 4 minutes remaining in a tight basketball game. It's a big three. Get the ball out of Harden's hands.
Man, George is open for the three. It's good.
I'm not sure they're going to run out there and double Harden on the point where he can go to the right wing or the left wing with the next pass.
Both of these teams in the bottom half of the league in clutch numbers, although Steph Curry will never be questioned in moments like this. Not sure Klay Thompson will either. The three. Rebound. Knocked out of bounds. 3:44 to play.
Out of bounds plays under the basket.
Clippers with their four best scorers on the floor right now. Late in the clock. Green, a heave. Great defense by the Clippers. 3:30 to play and a chance to pull them with a one, perhaps tie it with a three. Harden picked up by Curry. Down the lane. Powell for the tie. It was flat. 3:15 to play in the game.
What they brought him on the court for. They replaced Terrence Mann with Powell, who knocks those down normally.
Curry. And the rebound back tapped into the backcourt. Second effort for Golden State. Podziemski for another three. Rebound goes to George. Harden. Pull up for Kawhi is good. It's a one-point game.
When you see Kawhi pointing, talk about taking that man, take that man. I've got this guy. Communicated the defensive end. PG almost with the strip.
Curry bumped by Harden. They'll call it on the floor, but it's irrelevant. It'll be free throws for Curry and the Warriors. Now, we saw Curry miss two free throws on Thursday. I can guarantee you, you won't see that here.
Don't give him a second shot off a missed free throw.
2:22 to play, 3-point Warrior lead. They've led the entire game by as many as 22. Clippers have battled back really in the third quarter with 37 points. They've outscored the Warriors 19-15 here in the fourth, hitting half of their shots. Risky pass by Harden. It is kicked out of bounds. It'll stay with the Clippers. Plenty of time on the clock with 14 to shoot. Clippers got back into this game playing with speed and pace. Leonard, another pull-up, another bucket. 1 point game again with 2 minutes to play.
It should be five men with black jerseys on the glass when this shot goes up. Nobody should be running out or leaking out. Pressure Green. Don't give him a look at the court.
Curry. Blocked from behind. Out of bounds. Poljipski. It's Clipper ball. 107-106 going to break. The Warriors wanted to challenge this. And I'll tell you, as a lift leader and having also seen the replay, this is going to be Warrior basketball.
4.7 on the shot clock with a baseline throw-in for Golden State.
With 4.7 placed on the shot clock, it's quite obvious.
Harden's right hand, ball hits the ground off Harden.
We're going to have to go in a hurry. Into Poljipski and lays it in. Draymond Green, another play made, and a big bucket by the rookie. 109-106, Golden State.
It was the screen and the slipping of the screen after they set it that opened that wide up. I mentioned to you, Golden State has burned the Clippers a couple times on out-of-bounds plays underneath.
Big turnover. Moody is fouled. It was George going for the ball. It happened right in front of Kevin Cutler. Kevin Cutler was the one that ruled initially common foul. They're going to review it to see and make sure that that is not a take foul, which would be very costly. It's free throws either way for Golden State.
Play is under review to see if it meets the criteria for a clear path foul.
I think
upon review, Paul George was not ahead of the play at the time of the foul. It'll be a clear path to the basket.
Oh, wow.
He will shoot two free throws, and Golden State will get the ball on the side with 22 on the shot clock.
That's a big, big, big turn of events right there.
Okay, this is where Paul's ahead of him, but now when he fouls him, he's behind, and that's what they call.
J.J. Redick said that every single NBA Finals, that's how intense you have to be with all the back cut. Curry. Tend to shoot. Thompson catch and shoot. In and out. Rebound Leonard.
Bring it up with some pace now.
Clippers are down five. Harden attacks to the rim. Lays it in. 21 for Harden. 57 seconds to play.
When you're down five, you have to have two scores no matter what. You can get the three and the two or the two and the three. But you need two scores. They got one of them.
Curry takes his time. Taking some time off the ticker. Green, Moody. And Harden goes for a piggyback ride, a whistle and a foul. In the free throw line this afternoon.
You interrupt you, but it's important.
Makes the second. Timeout Clippers. 38 seconds to play. They're down by four.
To get a two for one, they wind up taking a bad shot.
George gets deep into the paint, hands it off to Leonard, lays it up and in. 112-110, timeout, send Golden State. Have one to give.
They have 11 seconds differential. Each team, one timeout remaining.
Curry, the pull-up. Rebound, Westbrook. The Clippers looking to push. The shot clock is dark. They're down by two. George wants it all. The three. Oh, my goodness. Hot damn. Paul George pushed the Clippers out in front by one.
What an incredible sequence.
Watched by Powell.
And Curry being guarded by Kawhi Leonard.
Green for the lead.
Clippers win! They battle back from down 22. Wow!
And the Nets with another opportunity with numbers if they hurry. Dinwiddie. Open. Bridges shooting practice. Bottom. In between Johnson and Thomas. He was looking for a cam, and he finally found one. Johnson on the attack. Get it to the outside. Swing it to the corner. Bridges, aggressive, puts it in.
Against the offense and on the quick penetration, Bridges right through the body of Patadze.
Second in the league in three-point percentage, 39%. Third in the league in threes made per game at 15.3. And we'll see if they can find an opening as Bridges, tough delivery, doesn't matter. Money in the mid-range. Bounce it. Bancaro's going to have to make it happen on Dinwiddie. Force it up. Oh! Sent away by Bridges. Dinwiddie. Kick out. Bridges. No hesitation. He's on fire.
Out of here and on the push. Getting it to the weak side. Cashing in. The Nets clicking early.
He almost doesn't do him enough justice. He's running around the floor. He's taking charges. Doing all the dirty work. Bridges. All he needs is a slither of space. And he buries another. Dennis Smith Jr. running the show, first game back after a six-game absence, baseline drive, Bridges, the sea is clear, and he's got 16 in the first.
And how they've come out and continued to play collectively, you see Mikal Bridges.
Smith will trigger. Sharp, back door, Bridges all day. Bridges, O'Neal. Does he have one final moment to cap it? Bridges, the drive, the finish! One-man wrecking crew, Mikal Bridges, beautifully done in this first at Barclays Center. Bridges, fantastic work, 8 for 11. The whammy power. Bridges, the fend-off, the fade, the finish! And recovered by Thomas. Great defensive possession. Nets looking to push. Thomas, bounce it. Bridges, Euro. Finish and the foul. Mikal Bridges, Brooklyn Bridges.
Impressive in this time, just slicing through the Euro. Ooh, that is nice.
Taking his time, sizing up Wagner. Knocking on the door of a 40 spot. Bridges got low, put it in, counted and a foul.
I mean, the blow by. He's got arms around him trying to wrap him up. Ain't nothing you could do to slow him down here tonight at the Clays. Kel has been, yeah. We see a new celebration with the bench. This has been going on, I think, for a couple games.
5 minutes to play. Bridges dancing, hesitates, gets inside, fades. Oh! He cannot be stopped.
So Bridges has been cooking. 42 points. Take a look at this shot. Taking a look at the Magic Ben. Tell him.
Team, I'm surprised they're not better defensively than what they are. And Brook gets his first. Looking for it. He's a short press. Bucks want to push a little bit. They got some numbers, 4-on-3. Chris hands it off to Giannis, flushes it. First dunk of the night and ties it at 15.
Double shot making, both teams well over 60%. Here's Chris with the drop off, and then I love it when Giannis just gets himself under control. You see Capella trying to set, you got to make it a finisher at the rim. Bogdan Bogdanovic.
Oh, good. Two-player game between Tame and Giannis. And
that's something that the Bucks have spent a lot of time working on in practice today.
Fade away for Trey. Marjan beating Giannis, the catch and the finish.
To the pass. We had Bobby streaking down the middle of the floor.
Well, we'll take Giannis instead. Yeah. Count the bucket and the foul.
Well, inability to get back in transition D. Nice job moving the basketball, and Giannis with the delayed cut weaves and winds his way around Bogdan Bogdanovic. You see the contact in the end.
23 points, I think, might be the high for the Bucks in a quarter. Got it against Dallas, and they're feeding Bobby Portis again in the dunker. Make it 42. Yep. Three in double figures, though, already for the Bucks. Still got it. basically the whole second quarter left to play. Malik Beasley on the break, and another two. His first two.
That's a great
48-43 advantage. Giannis pulls up from 15 out. Love seeing the pull-up jumper from him.
Yeah, and his defensive effort as a small ball four-man has been outstanding.
Giannis, look at what I found. Another dunk.
That's a well-executed play. Trae Young delivering to Sadiq Bey. Kind of caught Giannis sleeping.
Giannis gets his first two. Cutting Capella, the first block for Pep Lopez. And the finish from Giannis. A couple of those. Hawks have jumped out to a 15-6 advantage in the third quarter. Giannis right around the Hawks defense for another two.
Yeah, he just barely got that up, but not tonight.
Giannis was thinking of giving it back to Dame. The handoff is there. Pocket pass. Here comes Giannis with the challenge and lays it in with the left hand.
By Giannis' gait when he's in kind of domination mode. And right now he's in that mode, the way he is walking up and down the floor. You can
trigger there by the Hawks. Air ball by Hunter that time. Opportunity here for the Bucks. Here comes Dame. Off and running, gives it to Giannis right down the court. Holy Giannis!
Just a great job by Brook to shield off the potential offensive foul taker and DeAndre Hunter, and then Giannis, you know, he just elevates and throws it down. Give him a lane. Inside 15 feet on the move, which are awful difficult to knock down.
And the Hawks have responded with their own 7-0 run. Giannis going to take it right back. An and-one opportunity.
Ties up the arms. He can't budge, and all he can do is flail and foul, and Giannis can finish.
Changes, 7 ties here tonight. Giannis fakes the pass and spins left-handed hammer on Capella. Murray, good contest by Dame. Rebound by Chris.
That's a great contest.
Giannis all the way to the rack. Body bucket and one.
Giannis coast to coast. That quick crossover gets the angle on Sadiq Bey, and with his length, athleticism, and dancing ability, not a whole lot Bey can do about it. Oh, yeah. I'm nice.
Looking to close the deal. Dame, give it go. Here it is.
That's how you close the deal. West Dame, give it go with Giannis. He is way up over the rim. Thought about dunking it, but just wanted to make sure. He did kind of dunk that thing.
Giannis looks it off. He checks his feet. There it is. Oh, wiggle while you work. Is that what you say?
Wiggle while you work. Nearly 40%, and they have their first one of tonight's game on the heat by Lou Dort from up top.
Such an improved shooter. We know what he brings to the table defensively. His ability to stress the floor only.
58% on wing threes for Derrick Jones Jr. as Luka lays in his own initial missed shot. And 30% on corner threes for Derrick Jones. There's so much Williams going on right now. Jalen Williams, Kendrick Williams, Grant Williams. And then there's Aaron Wiggins out there too. Luka on the money.
One of the few good looks he's had this game so far. He's pretty much...
Thunder, meanwhile, have made 7 threes in the game. The number one three-point shooting team in the league. Here's Jones.
Look out.
And here is Jones. Look out below.
He's doing the right things defensively. He's not playing like a rookie.
Here's a catch inside by Lively, and he finishes. Ball tipped out by Lively off the missed three. The tip-out rebound for Dallas. They trail by 14. 4 minutes left in the first half. Here's Luka driving. There's contact. He finishes. Scoring has been his primary focus here in quarter number two. Now at 13 points and 7 assists, all courts for Luka. As Dallas comes away with it after a stop. Something that has been in short supply tonight as Luka drives through traffic to score. Josh Green out, right elbow sprain that happened during the game last night. Second straight game that Tim Hardaway's out. Back spasms. Slam dunk on the alley-oop by Derek Lively. You know, I'm not exactly sure on the J-Dub, J-Will thing.
Okay.
To be honest, for Oklahoma
State. Pass.
Here's Lively. Oh, and it's another rim rocker for Lively. Now Luka. looked at Wallace, passed it to Jones and Drano. Here in the middle of the third quarter, here's Luka. Knocks down a left wing three, down to 11.
Okay, they're not coming. Let me get one off real quick.
Oh my goodness, that's a flashback for some of our audience. Here's Luka maneuvering his way over to the wing, where he hits another step back. Here comes the double after Williams had switched on to Luka. Lawson back to back from Luka on threes.
Luka's smiling pretty big.
Yeah.
All right, youngin.
Put his hands together for a couple of claps.
Yeah. Keep doing that when I throw you the ball and you're wide open.
Gravel, Kendrick Williams. Assist number 11 here, Devin.
And rhythm shot. It helps when you just make one from the same spot. Put him in that position again.
Same situation. Oklahoma City a little bit better on the rotation. So Dallas has to make the extra pass, and it leads to a Seth Curry three. 36 minutes played tonight. Driving against Jalen Williams. There's help from the second defender. Omak's trying to get it back to Luka. Lands to the other end of the floor. Shot clock winding down. Lob, can't finish! Nice.
Lively did a good job showing himself to Luka, flashing to that spot. Perfectly placed pass.
And Lively's now 7 for 7 tonight. 16 points and 12 rebounds for Derek Lively.
Luka's waving him off.
And pokes it away from Chet Holmgren. Foot race into the backcourt. And the speedster to get there is A.J. Lawson. Finds Luka! Dallas has made a push in the third quarter. Oklahoma City had a response. Dallas got a stop out of the timeout. Oh. Man, with my peripherals, I can see a lot of people getting really pumped up, man. This place is getting ready to go bananas. Here is Luka putting it down, and it's no second chance basket. Seth Curry came flying in there, but extra bounce off the rim just kind of threw off the timing of it. He was seeking out an offensive rebound. Shea against Omak. Kick out pass. Nope.
I like what Omak was doing on Shea there. He's staying disciplined.
A lot of young fellas getting some time tonight. Omak, this is his ninth game. Here's Lively. Yes. Right down Broadway. Yes. Fancy finish. 18 tonight. A new career high in scoring.
Playing that high post to perfection, making plays.
Closes out here, Jalen Williams, runner, no. And the ball's out of bounds off Oklahoma City's Lou Dort.
Another stop. Doing a good job of recognizing playmaking in the middle of the floor. Made some good passes out of that position. Nice attack for the layup.
Yeah, he's had a good feel for when to pass or when to attack, Devin. And when he's attacked a couple of times, you saw him double clutch and jam it once.
Yeah.
And then he had the adjustment for the fancy little layup. Behind the back to Seth Curry. Bullseye!
That is so beautiful how they set that up. You cannot leave Seth. They did it, and Luka made them pay with that pass, and Seth with the shot.
16 straight. Oh, Luka! It's been 4 minutes since Oklahoma City has scored. Mavericks have the ball.
Took all of that.
Definitely a charge.
Yeah.
I'm going to put Seth in this first screen scenario, so if they trap.
They didn't trap that time.
No, they did not. Now it allows Luka to go to work.
Against Kendrick Williams, who just went into the game. Luka driving.
Yes.
Looks off the defense. If you want to see a building of 20,000 people going berserk, that is what is happening. People are losing their minds right now. Double on Shea, cross court, heck of a pass.
Great
Mason
close.
Wallace. Oh, shot clock winding down and runs out. Referees look at each other, thought there might be a jump ball for a moment, but it is a shot clock violation.
Place is woken up right now.
Yeah, you think?
Energy's what we needed in the building. Just effort, extra plays. Luka, no look. Rinse and reprise what you said.
Yeah.
They run the same play here. Double drag.
Yep, Curry screening, did a lively screening, and Luka driving on Kenrich Williams. Cross court, Derrick Jones! Yeah. Kenrich Williams to Lou Dort. Finds Cason Wallace for three. It's no good.
Let's go.
Run it again.
An absolutely unfathomable proposition.
Run it again. Run it again.
The Mavericks have a chance to tie or take the lead. It is Luka against Kenrich Williams. Lobbing.
Big stop. Chance for Mavs to take the lead here.
Here's Luka on the move. Luka. And Dallas has gone in front. 26 straight. Lou Dort for three. It's no good. You got it. 24-22 late in the first quarter.
It's
the last time Dallas went in front.
Oh.
Dallas sees a chance for a rebound. It's Derrick Jones Jr. with the putback. So the guys in the truck just told me that in 2021, the Mavs had a 28-0 run against Golden State. They've now tied.
Wow.
The longest run in team history.
Oh!
Eight straight. Luka just picked the pocket of Chet Holmgren.
Coming up on the two-minute mark. Sharp has caught fire. Brogdon as well. Five-point game. Collins puts a hand up. Dribble drive inside. Throw down. And that was with some attitude. Kamara.
Yeah, and that time, Ochai Agbaji gets driven on, and then Walker Kessler has to try to come over late and help. A little bit too late.
That's the first score for Kamara since two buckets in the first quarter. Now they put the clamps on. Collins passes over the top. Simone. Ball. Thibel got a piece. Got to get a stop here with a minute 30 left. And hanging on to a three-point lead. Aiden calls for it. Back down. Shaden Sharpe. Triple. Loose. Tapped over from Agbaji to Collins, and the Jazz and this crowd become riled up in the final minute and 15.
Good stop by the Jazz. You got to stay aggressive. Again, take care of the ball.
George drives off the rim. Walker was there to try to tip it in. Blazers with a chance to tie with a three under a minute to go. Brogdon has it out front, picked up by Collins on a buckle-up night in Salt Lake City. Brogdon double pumps, and he traveled. Or are they going to call a foul?
Well, he bumps John Collins on the drive. He's going to start on this end.
Jazz have two timeouts, no fouls to give. Both teams with a challenge if they need. Shaden Sharpe working one-on-one with Sexton. Forces the pass out. Here's Brogdon deep. And just like that, we're tied at 106. Timeout, Utah. Brogdon drops 25 on the Jazz. And a clutch bucket. Dante George breaks out. Chased by Kamara. Sexton wants to handle. What did we just say? Oh, costly. Costly. Jazz now have to play. Heads up deep. Sharp against a rookie. Keontae George.
He's going to take as much time as they can. Short shot clock here.
Sharp in traffic. Passes out. Brogdon just hit a three. Tough shot away. Short. Rebound. Collins. Oh, you've got to hold on it. And here we go. 5-3-2. Got to get the shot off. Overtime.
Well, the right move by Colin Sexton to stay aggressive. Just a better defensive play on the block. Right here, shot awareness, shot clock awareness. There was some contact there, but looks like
Kamara
went straight up.
Brogdon came up big late with that deep three. There's a cutter down inside and a two-hander by Sharp.
Just cannot happen. Miscommunication. Guy gets beat up top. Everyone has to be aware and talk.
47 points between Brogdon and Sharp in this game. The two backcourt starters. George.
The ball has stayed up top in the last two series.
Keontae, floater. Up and in. Tough shot. 20 gives this young rookie his career-high 20-point night.
Nice aggressive move by Keontae that time.
Tied at 108. Sharp pops out for three. 25 for Shaedon Sharpe.
He has really struggled all year for the Portland Trail Blazers, and this is a breakout game for Shaedon Sharpe.
Back comes Jurt, 7.
Omer. Great execution that time off the pick and roll. Perfectly executed. Omer, you're at 7. Gets away for the slam.
Can't trade. Threes and twos. Brogdon out behind the three-point line. As we roll up on 3 minutes to play, Sharp gives it away to Brogdon. Those two have been dynamic in the final minutes of the fourth to force overtime. Brogdon, one-on-one with George, stays right in front, forces the pass. It's a three. Oh, my, the bank shot. Kamara's arms around like, hey, not my fault. He hits the triple, and it's a four-point lead.
That's what happens when you have a straight line on that shot to the basket. Backdoor could be your friend.
Sexton spins, passes out. Collins on a catch and shoot. Bang! John Collins.
Jazz getting back to that ball movement, making the Blazers play D. Now it's their turn to see if they can get the Blazers to cough one up.
Sharp again for a triple short. That falls into the arms of Keontae. He runs by 1, 2, 3 red jerseys. Collins push, no call. He's trying to drive inside. Yurt, 7, hooking. Comes off the rim to Aiden. Under 2 minutes left in overtime. Blazers by one. Jazz 0-1 in overtime this year. 7 to shoot, down to 6. Kamara pushes away. Keontae George floats it up one hand twice and got it.
Wow, Keontae got it run over.
How is that not a foul?
I think Will Hardy's asking exactly the same question. That's interesting. The shot, they're going all the way back to the 255 mark.
Yeah, I saw John Collins, you know.
Oh, yes, perfect. Great review. So Kamara's three, they erased that.
It's huge.
Will inbound again. Backward pressure will be applied by the Blazers. George says, direct that pass to Collins, and they do.
He's got
to
hurry.
He fumbled the ball, and an easy. Oh! Brogdon missed that shot.
Yep, they got a foul there. Colin Sexton wanted that foul. Jazz just, they're getting pressure here. They have got to be aggressive offensively.
Gert Seven pops out to screen. Keontae George inside. Put it down. Okay. And the Jazz retake the lead. 115-113. Yurt Seven with an 8-point game. Making his fifth start. Brogdon in the paint. Behind the back pass, grabs it back in the corner. Yurt Seven with a defensive rebound. Under a minute to play in the Jazz by a bucket.
That dude's a magnet, man, on both ends of the court. Knowing where to put his body. Omer Yurt Seven.
15 rebounds for Yurt Seven. I'm tied in, T. Let's go. 40 seconds of play, 4 to shoot. Down to 3. George, short. Rebound, Ayton. Brogdon across midcourt. He calls for Shaedon Sharpe.
No space on the threes.
10 to shoot, 22 to play. Jazz by a bucket in overtime. Sharpe, dribble drive, a pass, Fontecchio. Oh, nice job. Collins, Yurt Seven stood his ground defensively.
Wow.
That last whistle was on Kamara, number 4. Free throw, sweet. This is a big free throw to make it a 4-point spread. It's up. It's good.
2-possession game, boy. That's what you want.
Brogdon gets it back on the inbound. Drives in on Keontae. Blocked! Blocked! Blocked by Yurt Seven!
Yes, sir.
Oh, this guy gets a game ball and then some. Jazz with her 10th block. 7 seconds to play. Brogdon pulls a trigger on a 3. Out it comes, put back, no. And a loose ball foul. Jazz with her 10th block. 7 seconds to play. Brogdon pulls a trigger on a 3. Out it comes, put back, no. And a loose ball foul. So quiet this building became as future, present, and future. You miss the second, the shot clock or the game clock runs dry. The Jazz in overtime.
And he'll play at 100 miles an hour. He has just grown up his game.
Nice lob to Reggie Jackson, who drops it in.
He's using speed. Look at Reggie going to catch his lob.
There's a couple of steals. Jackson around the corner. Reggie going to back up, pull the trigger. No, give it to Jokic, and Jokic puts it to bed and a foul.
Well, that's a great play. You get the big out. Fox just shoves Joker for a little bit. Sometimes
he's now 27 years old. Jokic trying to get around the corner, and he spins it up and in. Stumbling, rumbling for a deuce there. Into Gordon. He's in deep. Give it back to Jokic. Jokic's little hook shot. That's good. So Nikola Jokic, you're going to get some foul trouble guarding Durant. And now the Nuggets trying to get the lead back. Jokic has it. His little floater is good. Dead spot for the Denver Nuggets defense. And anybody's defense in the NBA.
Yeah.
Now Jokic. And he's bumped and throws it up and in. So a potential 3-point play.
It's a bonus, his second foul. He just spins off him quick. Just a little chesty with him. And how about the touch? See, their hand spins. Just kind of, he's kind of leaning in. Not a lot of contact.
Peyton Watson. Back to Jokic. 8 to shoot. Jokic wheels into the key. Hook shot. That's good, too. And he is putting on a Serbian clinic. Oh, he passed up what looked like a good shot. Gets it back. Shoot it. Now Jokic will put it in. And Jokic is now 7 of 11.
Well, now it's a 27-7 run. Christian Brown, floater good. Nuggets finally score and get off 34. Head to Porter. Get the Jokic underneath the Gordon, and he puts it away. And I think you got to go for some more dunks, too, don't you? It's a 10-point lead. JaVale off the bench. 8 points, 5 rebounds. As you look at the bench scoring, was that 24-9? It was.
Kind of watch Joker here take it over for us.
Reggie Jackson back in for Denver. Jokic has it. 4 to shoot. Jokic over the top, and he gets the 16-footer.
See if the Nuggets can get going here at the top of the third. Jokic only got two shots in that second quarter, Scott, after scoring 16 in the first. Christian Brown handling, getting some pressure. Now Jokic. And Jokic knocks in the jump shot. Spacing not good. Jokic with 10 to shoot. Underneath to Christian Brown. What a pass by Jokic. We have just under 90 seconds to keep it up. Down the middle to Watson. Watson put it up and in off the glass. One assist shy of a triple-double. Strother. Jokic coming around the horn. Back to Julian.
Oh, we got to shoot that.
Jokic baseline. Got it. Nikola Jokic with his 29th point. Saw Kevin Huerter come back in. There's the bench story. Jokic drops it in and the foul.
And you know what? That's not much contact either. Big guy is a little bump chest call. Right there, he kind of leans in.
And Sabonis now with 17. Kings with 5 in double figures. Underneath Caldwell Pope, another assist for Jokic. Reggie Jackson under duress, and he knocks in the triple. And that's a good way to get a rally started. Around the screen, Reggie tied up. Jokic straightaway three. Yes! Nikola Jokic buries one from the top of the key. Got to get a quickie here. Jokic dumping under, and they get the quick two. Now you have to play the foul game.
Switch on defense. Martin now picked up by Portis. Middleton goes
on
the
floor. Boy, come on now, Shaq.
Boy, a fundamentally sound machine.
Yes, thank you, Shaq.
Boy, are you not entertained?
Look at the footwork.
Big go up there, big fella, by Lopez. And it looks like Kevin Love is turning right into him. I don't see how this is an offensive foul on Lopez. To me, this is an and one for Brook Lopez.
A lot of the time when the players, the offensive players, contact above the shoulders, it's going to be offensive.
What do you want Lopez to do? Bring the ball down? You're taught, no, don't bring it down because the guard will steal it. I catch it and I'm going up in my motion.
I can't believe you're sticking up for the big guys, because if I would have did that move, you'd have been like,
you did this all the time to Rick.
I did. And Rick should have known, keep your face out the path of my elbows.
It's got to be. It's got to be.
Adebayo's got 27 and 10. Shot clock at 6. Lowry on the perimeter. Love in the corner. 3-2. Hawkins got it. Cleans it up and puts it in.
I'm changing his name to Hawker J.
To what?
Hawker J. Like I said, not going to get a lot of playing time, but when they ask you to come out and do whatever, you do it right there, wide open shot. Every coach in the world will let you take that shot. Except Charles Barkley, because he can't shoot.
Oh, shots fired.
Same shots.
Oh, it's real.
Yeah, these are facts.
See if Richardson got all ball here. Oh, he sure did.
Hand is part of the ball. Stop.
What? What is wrong with you, Shaq? You've gotten soft.
I'm just going by the letter of the law.
You've gotten soft since you put on a suit and tie. Hand is part of the ball. Come on, man.
Hand is part of the ball.
You have gotten soft. You used to be the baddest man on the planet, and now you're talking about hand is part of the ball?
He grabbed his hand, Reggie. Stop him. Don't let him finish similar to the line. But I'm guaranteeing Giannis is going to make two right now.
Oh, come on. Stop it.
Bet it.
Stop it.
Out of the gumbo. I saw that wad in your pocket. Come on, man. Stop it.
You want to bet it right now?
I can't match your wattage at all.
Here it comes.
But
right
he's
now.
Not making both.
He's 3-6.
That's 50%. That's good enough. Here we go. Yakek.
Oh, look at that.
Shaq Thomas is never wrong. 3-6 means he's in the rhythm.
That's what Wait, that it means. Does?
Yes.
Oh, for him?
Yes.
So for you, 3-6 was you were in a rhythm.
It means the more attempts I got, the more I got into a rhythm.
Okay.
This is good right here.
Over the last 9 games, Giannis has averaged 34.
Yama. Shaq Thomas is always right.
Look at you.
I know the game, Reggie.
He's up to 14 now.
Giannis with a three.
once you hit that free throw, two in a row, I'm telling you, it gets you in the rhythm.
Would you have came down and take a three?
I sure would have not. I sure would have not.
That he's on this Milwaukee team.
Yes, they are. They're expected to win. And yes.
Montez with Lopez, who knocked the ball away. Richardson got it and scoops it home.
Scoop-de-loop, Kevin. Let me hear you say it.
And the one and only, or perhaps I should say the 41-21 one and only, Dirk Nowitzki is our guest analyst tonight.
I'm thrilled to be here tonight. This is going to be a roast session again. Added some veteran leadership and guys that can play, so it'll be a fun game.
There's Shingun.
There he is.
Yeah.
Is that maybe a tribute Jokic to you? Is that,
I heard he's been working on that. It looks pretty smooth, I got to say.
All right, Shingun with the Dirk.
Oh, that's beautiful right there. Good defensive end. That's great.
And no surprise here.
There's
Dylan
no
Brooks
defense
guarding
against
Luka.
That. There's no defense against that. Uncle Jeff still out there doing his thing.
Oh,
that's awesome.
Got a championship.
Got that chip last year. I was happy for him. He's a good dude.
Great dude.
He has been in the league for 27 years.
Yeah.
Not quite that long.
Oh.
He balls out of bounds off him, though.
Challenge everything. If you ask Luka, just watch Luka. He's Mark Cuban over there with his finger all the time. Hey, challenge. Look at staring him down, talking to him during the play. It's awesome.
Ball changes hands between he and Dante Exum. Irving stops and nails the shot.
Stop on a dime, go up. Left, right, doesn't matter. Great pull-up.
Who had his pathway to the NBA paved by the guy to my right.
Step back.
Luka on the money.
You know, going left, his step back is money. I mean,
because you guys went to one ALCS game and then game two of the World Series.
Exactly.
Well.
But you know what? They got it done, and I'm so happy for him. It's been obviously a long time. Let me tell you something. I used to take my head off going in the basket. The good old days. always tough. I just didn't. I was never a good ladder. Take that with you. I was never a great ladder.
Was just putting in against Dylan Brooks.
Yeah, he's got to work hard, but hey, he's so skilled. Spin, no help there.
Almost a pre-rotation.
Yeah.
You got
to. I think Jones almost rotated back to his own instead of just going weak. That messed up the whole rotation.
Chance for Dallas to get the 3 points right back.
Is that his fourth foul on Brooks?
Yes, that it is. Four fouls on Brooks and now three team fouls on.
Luka's got to be the best horse player I've ever seen. I mean, he is making some straight garbage. Unbelievable.
I'm glad Brad is still getting some love.
Oh, Brad's my guy.
Of course, old Mav fans remember the Corolla Rolla and the Camry Jams.
You guys hustle and I'll wait somewhere standing. Come on, get the loose ball so I can shoot that thing.
The plays that used to get us hyped the most was when you dive on the floor and you get a charge.
Like, you could probably count it on one hand.
Hey, but those are big, they were the big plays for us.
So the green light, you can miss obviously four or five and nobody's going to say anything and you still have to shoot.
He got hot up
to give you 30. He's been on an incredible pace all season long. Take it away, Mark.
As a matter of fact, you can count
on to
give him
30. I got this from here. Okay. 11 30-point games. He's tied with Embiid and Gilgeous Alexander, but incredible offensive weapon. When we talk about Luka so much, I mean, unbelievable. He can score in so many ways. He can pass. He can hurt you. If you trap him, he can hurt you. I mean, he is an amazing player.
And proved this year, 11th in the NBA this season, 46.5.
Let's do this.
Timeout, Houston. Derek Lively upstairs.
Bring the house down. Bring the house down.
And so the Rockets, for a moment, stopped the bleeding. Dallas had lifted the lead.
Too little.
Spin move and score for Luka. 37 in the game. Brooks got back on Luka. 3-point attempt off target. Long rebound.
Didn't have his balance there. Okay.
Flexion. Ball still falls into the hands of Kyrie. Double team, steps through it, picks it up, finishes. Chicken salad play, Kyrie Irving. And Luka against Green. Blocked shot, Jalen Green. And a save and attempt is picked up by Luka.
Oh, no. The hook shots. Skyhook.
First in the last 2 minutes.
He went with the third.
That's actually a good block and then kind of made. But look how easy it makes it look. I mean, I'm telling you, his horse game is out of control.
He's helped Dallas with offense in the flow of the game and free throws here in the fourth quarter. Jabari Smith Jr.
Why did we leave him open?
Oh, he's. And here is Jones up ahead. He's leaked out.
Shut it down. Let's go home.
3 seconds, a three, no good, and it's all over. Dallas wins. Dallas got the ball in bounds.
MVP.
It's a quiet 41, huh?
41 tonight.
A quiet,
how fitting.
A quiet 41.
Let's speak it into existence. There it is. 41.